Don't cancel Kid Rock show. They'll tear the place down. You saw that?
Yeah. Kind of felt like misguided anger.
Go ahead.
Be mad at Mother Nature or Kid, but you're taking it out on the security people who have no factor in that decision-making process.
Yeah. So it's hard to say. It's hard to know exactly what story is true yet. But what I've seen is that Kid Rock and Night Ranger were playing at the North Dakota State Fair in Minot. And there was a tornado warning.
Yeah.
No, there's a tornado watch and there's a tornado warning. Tornado mm-hmm. watch means, hey, you know, it doesn't look good.
Mm-hmm.
It's like, this is the kind of stuff where a tornado could happen. These kind of clouds, this kind of temperature change. But they issued a tornado warning, which means we've seen a tornado. And they canceled the show because of a tornado.
Mm-hmm.
And they refused to go home.
Instead, let's throw beer cans.
And they ended up causing more damage than the tornado.
Yeah.
Oh, wow.
They trashed the place. 18,000. Well, what do you want? They've been watching Night Ranger for 2 hours.
Ouch.
Come on. Come on, Sister Christian.
Uh-huh.
2 hours. Even with a multi-extended DJ Jazzy Jeff version of Sister Christian, there's no way Night Ranger's going for 2 hours.
Who knew?
Hmm. Oh, and I heard there was booze, too.
Yeah. Imagine that.
One way or another, that North Dakota State Fair was going to get wrecked.
Indeed.
Either by a tornado or 18,000 drunk Kid Rock fans.
Yeah. Just want our Kid Rock.
Kid Rock, apparently very upset, tweeted, I am so pissed off. While quite a distance away from the trouble.
Yeah.
Uh-huh. Yeah. None of that ever happens to me when I'm just sitting at home, minding my own business,
mm-hmm.
being very quiet.
No one protests that.
Mm-mm.
That's good.
Mm-mm. There's no trouble. I don't have 18,000 screaming, drunk, beer and urine soaked fans screaming, ba with a ba da ba ba da ba da da.
No.
No.
Okay. Just can't imagine being so upset a concert got canceled that I want to trash the place.
No, well, I can't imagine you would either. But I also can't imagine you at a Kid Rock concert.
No.
I can imagine you at a Carpenters concert.
Hey!
Or
Jacoby Kelly.
Yes.
I can imagine them canceling a Jacoby Kelly concert.
Mm-hmm.
Not because of a tornado.
But because Colby was feeling a little blue.
And so 18,000 fans broke into a Starbucks
and they had a latte. With little decorative motifs in the top of their foam.
The only way to feel better.
Yeah. Can I do some inflation compensation?
Yeah.
$1,000 for you right now. Inflation compensation. Yeah, your politicians can't get a handle on inflation. We'll do it for you. Once again, leave it to the true heroes, the DJs.
Mm-hmm.
We'll take care of it for you. No problem. Here we go. You go to 101kgb.com. Inflation compensation comes up right on the front there. And that's how you win $1,000, pretty much just by clicking on that. Oh, by the way, it's going to say, hey, what's the keyword for this hour?
Mm-hmm.
And that keyword is green. G-R-E-E-N, green, which is the color of?
Grass at the state fair.
My daughter's garlic.
Oh.
Just take me a picture. Is your garlic supposed to turn green in the oven?
In the no, I've never witnessed
so.
That.
No.
Mm.
A little suspect.
I don't know. This she sent me this picture. I don't know. It looks like someone cut open something they found on the bottom of the ocean.
Ew.
This is terrible. Look at that. Isn't that awful looking?
Ew, that's her meal?
Before she ate it.
It doesn't look like that.
I know. She texted me out of the blue.
Ew.
Look at this. It's so gross. It's like, and I was cooking dinner. It's like, I don't want to see this. My garlic turned green in the oven. I'm like, why are you sending me this? She goes, it could be fun to talk about tomorrow on your radio show.
I'm having fun.
Okay.
Yeah?
Yeah.
I'll text her back. Chainsaw, had fun. Nationwide keyword is green, G-R-E-E-N. Go to 101kgb.com. Click on that. Send in the word. Get $1,000. All right. Very good. Good nice. Weekend for everybody.
Yeah, yes. It was lovely.
And I don't think you? I saw any. Yes. I did see a movie.
The Gray Man?
No.
Oh. What did you see then? You didn't. Were you at Crawdads?
Yeah.
You went to see the Crawdads thing?
Yeah. Yeah.
What?
That's the right voice for it, too. I didn't know.
What?
I didn't know.
Hey.
I didn't know.
I read the book. I liked it.
Oh,
really?
My God.
Yeah.
Duh.
What?
Jesus, I thought I was in trouble.
What? I don't even know you two.
It's a good mystery.
You
Is
know,
it?
It's a murder mystery.
Okay.
But it's a chick movie.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah, look at us. Aren't we something special?
Yeah. Survivalist.
Want to hold hands?
No.
No. Yeah.
Maybe later. No, survivalist, mystery movie. I liked it. Of course, all the girls I know recommended it. So
right.
Yeah.
I thought it was a chick book.
It pretty much is. But it had enough to keep me engaged because it talked about a place and time that I found interesting. And how was the movie, Dave?
No, keep going.
No.
Keep going, Martha.
Well, I mean, the girl in the book is supposed to be, you know, like out living in a kind of brown, tanned and everything. So they hired this porcelain Brit chick to do it. So I'm already kind of bummed about that.
Not
Sorry.
Who you pictured in your mind.
Right.
Sorry.
How much did you spend? I think more
or
than
did you
I
go to. The, did you go to the movie?
No, I haven't seen the movie yet.
You're disappointed in a movie you didn't see?
The yes, and that's
like
how
casting.
We roll here. Disappointed in the casting?
You're disappointed in a movie that you didn't see and aren't going to see.
I'm probably going to see it and hate
oh,
it.
Oh, what?
Wait, are you going to go to the theater?
You got no one to blame now.
Yeah, no question.
You're still going to go see it.
Probably, yeah.
Movies are never, ever
right.
as good as the books, say the snobby, snotty, snooty book people.
And that's me.
I read the book. Why?
Well, it's locked in our imagination of how we see it, and then it's not how it is, you know, we see it, etc. When they do the film, and they always change it somehow.
Mm-hmm.
How was it? Out of 10. 5.
That's
a 4.
I'll tell you what was great was that what's the ice cream place with a bear in the
Baked
name?
Bear.
Baked Bear. Was open for 2 more minutes when we got outside.
Uh-huh.
And so
okay.
I went to Baked Bear for the very first time.
All right.
Oh, that was a first for you.
Redemption. That was a 10.
Redemption. Yeah.
Yeah.
That
okay.
was a 10.
Yeah, Baked Bear is fantastic.
Yeah, I felt a little rushed. I didn't really know what I was doing.
Mm.
You know, it's a different kind of ice cream store. It's not like just going and it's, you know, some ice cream, most ice cream stores, your biggest challenge is going to be, are you getting it in a cup or are you getting it in a cone? If you're getting it in a cone, what kind of cone? And there are some challenges there, and then there's sprinkles afterwards. And so there's plenty to deal with there. This place, what's it called?
Baked Bear.
Baked Bear. That's completely different.
Yeah.
And I was brand new there, and I didn't know the procedure. I didn't know what the menu was. I mm-hmm. didn't know what I was doing.
Mm-hmm.
I got away with it. I got lucky, but I need to go back now that I know what's going on.
Yeah. Yep. Take your time, really. Look at your options.
That was good stuff.
Yeah.
I really enjoyed
mm-hmm.
it. That was the best part of the night.
Yeah, mm-hmm. I can imagine.
Yeah. It was really good.
I saw your wife post that she was seeing that movie, and I thought to myself, oh, she must be having a girl's night while Dave stayed home to watch The Gray Man.
No. No, we wanted to go to the movies, and the options were Maverick, which we've seen, Mrs. Harris Goes to Paris. And it's what? Like, that sounds like, yeah. Which is getting huge ratings.
Huh.
That did not sound good to her. I showed her the preview of the Crawdads one.
Mm-hmm.
And she said, yeah, let's go see that one. So I was like, okay, fine. I just wanted to go to the movies. I didn't care.
Gotcha.
Yeah. And it's is it a chick movie? Pretty much. But it's not like The Piano or Beaches. It's not that bad. It's not The Notebook bad.
Okay.
It's not The Notebook bad.
Okay.
But
it's in the neighborhood.
No.
It's in the vicinity.
It's right next door.
Okay. They have the same HOA payment. They're in the same area.
But man, I got ice cream and cookies.
Yeah, you did.
At the end. Okay, what are we going to talk about in sports next here at Chainsaw?
A possible sweep in New York, Hall of Fame inductees, and a TikTok fail.
TikTok fail? F-A-I-L?
Yes.
Oh, I love fails. All right, get the Chainsaw next year on the DSC show.
Chain, chain, chain.
Because we're Renaissance men.
Thank you.
We like to be open to all
thank
things.
Yeah.
Here's the Chainsaw Talking Sports Now with the KJB. Good morning.
Oh, well, good morning, and thank you, David, and hello again, everybody in the sports world. The Padres were going for the sweep in New York yesterday, which New Yorkers would have appreciated because there's a lot of garbage on the streets. But alas, this was baseball, a series against the Mets. The Padres won the first two games, but then there was yesterday.
2-1 to Alonso.
Yeah.
Here's the pitch. Swing on a high fly ball, well hit, left center, she's on the way, and there it goes! A three-run homer for Pete Alonso over the Great Wall of Flushing to the right of the 370.
The Great Wall of Flushing?
With this crowd here at City Field, his 25th home run of the year.
Yeah.
The Mets are leading by a score of 3-1.
Yeah, once down 8-1, the Padres scratched back to make it an 8-5 final. Now 54-43. Now 54-43. The Padres are now 11.5 games behind the Dodgers in the division. So maybe we should just forget about that and focus on the wild card playoff spot that the Padres have right now. They're handing out three of them, and the Padres are in the number two spot by three games over the third spot. Yeah.
Okay.
Padres visit the Detroit Tigers tonight through Wednesday. The Tigers are in last place in their division with the fourth worst record in all of baseball.
They stink!
First pitch, 4:10 our time tonight. Boston Red Sox legend David Ortiz, Big Poppy, was inducted into the Baseball Hall of Fame, and he says a diminutive teammate, Dustin Pedroia, motivated him one time.
All I was trying to do, it was bringing team together. My smaller teammate, where he at, Pedroia? Pee Wee grabbed me by the neck one time, and he told me, if you keep on pulling the ball, I'm gonna whoop you. And guess what? Big Poppy got caught up on fire. And I'm going to thank you guys for the rest of my life.
Mm-hmm. See that? Reverse motivation. I like that. Also inducted yesterday was 83-year-old former pitcher Jim Cott, who pitched for 25 seasons for five different ball clubs back during a simpler time when only buckets of greenies were placed in front of every locker instead of steroids. You know. No, greenies. Like those little pill pockets for dogs, right? Is that what I'm talking about?
If you say so.
Okay. Meanwhile, in the National Bell?
I got dogs. I got two dogs. I got a pregnant dog. I have a golden retriever. We have two of them. Oh, you have a golden retriever? Yeah, great. Small world. So,
Son of a dick.
The dogs are mating, and I didn't know. My little girl, I have a six-year-old, she comes in and goes, Daddy, the dogs are stuck together. Go to your room. So I go, wow, the dogs are humping. So the first thing I do is I want to make sure I got, a fresh battery in the video camera. And I go outside and they're not humping. They're stuck together, ass to ass. And they're looking at me like, help. Are you going to do something about this? So my neighbor comes over and he goes, wow, if they're stuck together ass to ass, that means they're definitely pregnant. That, you know. So I never had puppies before. So a few weeks later, I called the vet at PetSmart and I said, how do I know if my dog's pregnant? And the guy goes, are her nipples sensitive?
Oh.
Yeah, I think so, because last night when I was sucking them, she bit me. And the guy hung up on me.
Football Association. Brooklyn Nets superstar Kevin Durant, who's known for being a bit touchy about social media trolls, he's really asking for it now. He sent out his very first TikTok the other day, still figuring it out. 6 seconds of him just staring at the camera and then saying, how do I work this, she-ite?
Yeah. Hmm.
Kevin, you're only 33, but you're totally a boomer.
Yeah.
Welcome aboard. In other sports, David.
In chess sports, Chainsaw.
Yeah.
There was a 7-year-old chess prodigy playing against an AI, artificial intelligence robot,
okay,
in Russia. And apparently the little kid was playing too fast, too smart for the robot. And the kid started to make a move right away, and the robot couldn't take it. So the robot grabbed the little kid's finger and broke it.
What? Oh, God.
Yeah, yeah. Well, that's the robot. That's the AI equivalent of flipping the chessboard over. Yeah. And the kid was moving really fast, and the robot couldn't keep up, so the robot grabbed the kid's finger and snapped it.
Always good to program a little rage.
And the little kid starts crying.
Yeah.
Carrying on like a baby.
God, baby. Kids. It is 8:38. 6:33 in 4 seconds, and this is your 101.5 KGBFM Sports Network. Oh, my!
Home of the DSC. KGB.
Is anybody planning on going to see Elton John?
Yeah.
Yep.
We have our tickets. Mm-hmm.
Which show did you get?
Petco Park.
That was added after the announcement of the tour, right?
I believe so, yeah.
Here's another one. Las Vegas.
Ooh.
Just added. And KGB has your chance to jet to Vegas for an evening with a Rocket Man. Listen to what you get. Elton just added this Las Vegas show. You and a guest will fly to Las Vegas. Doesn't say here if we're buying the tickets. It's just, I think that's kind of assuming.
Yeah, risky to assume, but.
Does that mean we're giving them plane tickets?
Yes, we are.
We are. You want to guess, we'll fly to Las Vegas to see the Farewell Yellow Brick Road Tour. You'll take a VIP behind-the-scenes tour. Get a picture of yourself at Elton's piano.
Wow.
Yeah. Even get a personal video from Elton to help you remember it all for a lifetime. All thanks to AEG. Go to iHeartRadio.com/Elton John to enter now.
Cool.
I wonder how you win. Is it just like a random drawing for everybody who enters this contest?
I believe it is.
That's pretty cool. Yeah, sitting at the piano, that'd be pretty cool.
Yeah, iconic.
What if you get like macaroni and cheese, though, all over his piano case?
Oh, I don't think that would go well.
Let's use a wet nap before you sit down at Elton's piano, huh?
Yeah.
All right, that's all waiting for you at iHeartRadio.com/Elton John. Your chance to go to Las Vegas. And all that cool behind-the-scenes VIP stuff. All right, Emily, what's happening in our world of half-baked crackpot news today?
I spent my morning reading why NASA scientists don't think astronauts should masturbate in zero gravity.
Does it matter if they're male or female?
Yeah, the males should not.
Should not.
Right.
Well, I know why.
I didn't.
Wait, what?
Tell me.
You don't need to be out there in the International Space Station with gobs of putty flying around. Right?
Yeah. And that's what it is.
Uh-huh. You didn't think about that?
No, I didn't. Imagine that. I didn't think about astronauts whacking it. So.
I think about it all the time.
Yeah. It'll short out the equipment. What equipment? Well, the space station.
Got it.
What if they had a special astronaut relief tube?
Go ahead.
Well, I mean, they've got a place for you to go to the bathroom. And they, what if you just relieved yourself into that device? That would capture it.
They have them for sale. We talked about those things.
Well, we'll hear more about this coming up. The Crackpot News. Maybe all questions will be answered, right?
Maybe just more questions will come up. I'm not sure.
I don't know. I mean, they had a guy up there for a year.
Mm-hmm.
Remember that guy?
Yeah.
Arizona guy or something like that?
Something like, yeah.
You tell me that guy didn't do anything for a year? Come
a year.
On.
Right.
Every day.
Not supposed to.
Maybe they got just some special wall.
Ew.
What?
Nothing at all.
After a while, it becomes a rock climbing wall.
Yeah.
Exercise and that at the same two birds.
Imagine how virile and forceful chainsaw you would appear in zero gravity.
Wow.
They wouldn't need retro rockets on the moon.
I mean, it just... Yeah. Wow, that guy's a shooter.
Yeah.
That's how we judge ourselves.
Yeah.
Got it. Okay. Yeah.
Some guys are like lawmen. Some guys are just like little dribblers. You never know. But in zero gravity, everybody's like the Lone Ranger.
Right. No dribble.
It's pretty cool.
Very.
You brought it up, not me.
I know.
Go ahead.
So apparently in Argentina, their country is going through rampant inflation, and we can relate. There was a presidential spokeswoman, though, who wasn't so worried about all that was going on. And didn't think about the fact that if you comment on things on Instagram, the whole country can see it. So she was spending her downtime entering a win a dildo contest.
Win a dildo? Is it a new one?
I hope it's a new dildo.
Yeah.
Although I believe
Secondhand Dildos was one of my first bands.
I think so. Yeah. Uh-huh. And I was reading a story about how unused sex toys that have been deemed not safe by the manufacturer are now being upcycled to be made into sneakers.
I have a pair of sneakers that I bought that I didn't buy them for this reason, but one of the pitches on them is they're made out of recycled water bottles.
Okay. Mm-hmm.
And there's only one problem with these sneakers.
Hmm.
They feel like they're made out of recycled water bottles.
The worst.
You ever buy like a pair of shoes? Like for me, it's shoes. You buy it and you're just trying to convince yourself that you like them. Yeah. And it's just like, no, this is, you know,
mm-hmm.
I bought inserts for these things, you know, trying to make it
salvage
work.
It.
Just,
I got to feel good right off.
Quit.
Man.
Throw these things out.
Yeah.
Buying crap online. You know, I never would have done it if I'd been at Nordstrom buying them or something like that. But I bought these online. It's like, hey, those look like a nice pair. Just wanted a pair of black sneakers. They're made out of recycled water bottles. These would serve a better purpose if they were part of the floating garbage heap out in the middle of the ocean. Worst shoes ever. Cycle these back into water bottles. All right. What else?
Half of Americans now watch TV with closed captioning and subtitles on.
Every day.
Yes.
Yes, me too.
I've been a proponent of this for years.
Mm-hmm. And it's becoming more and more popular, and a lot of shows are getting in on it and trying to make their subtitles noteworthy. Stranger Things is one that's been really popular for this, where they have a lot of sounds that they're trying to describe and make it just over-the-top descriptions.
They're stupid. No, seriously. I watched the Stranger Things when my kid was in town.
Yeah.
And they're stupid with their closed captions.
They're doing
the way
that.
They describe their music and their sounds.
They're trying to add.
It's a pain in the ass because it's like, okay, someone just got a thesaurus and they're using all these fancy words. And you find yourself sitting there thinking about the descriptive words about the music that they're playing.
Do you remember any? Like what?
I don't because it was just so over the top.
That's so annoying.
I think it is. I mean, I like the closed captions just for the dialogue. I don't need it for any of the sound effects at all. Just the dialogue. That's all I need. Because I can't keep up. And I promise you, with closed captions, you get more dialogue. You'll catch more than you would without it.
Mm-hmm.
Sometimes dialogue is so quiet, so muted, or whatever. Closed captions gives you everything.
Mm-hmm.
And there have been important plot lines that went by that I would not have caught.
Same.
But with
Stranger Things.
With this Stranger Things, they want you to understand the feeling of every single note of the music that's playing. Strangely muted, quietly hurtful music playing in the back. It's all right already. It's annoying as hell.
Ominous synth music right. Plays.
What is it?
Ominous synth music plays.
Yeah, ominous synth. It's just all right. Oh,
wet footsteps squelch.
Squelch! I remember that. Squelch.
I like squelch? It. I don't have to think. What does that mean? What is squelching?
Yeah, that's squelch.
It's like
right
being
there.
On the International Space Station. Wet footsteps. Well, you walked right through the whack area, Bob. What do you want?
On a snail.
Yeah, squelch is the sound of you stepping on a snail
that's
outside
not a
the
good
iHeart.
Sound.
No, it's not. Yeah. I'm a big fan of it, but.
Delicate, yearning music playing.
Oh, God.
Seriously. It's like you're reading a birthday card from your grandparents. I don't know. It's delicate yearning music. Delicate yearning music?
Tentacles undulating moistly.
Yes!
Okay, no.
Yes, I remember all this.
Moistly?
What?
Undulating moistly.
What a hideous show.
God, I'm not watching that thing.
All right, anything
so
else?
So anyway, subtitles are all the rage and they're gaining popularity. So a study was done to determine which actor is the most difficult for Americans to understand that drives them to those subtitles.
Really?
Yeah.
Ooh, I'll be interested in hearing this.
Mm-hmm.
As a big fan of closed captions.
Yeah, absolutely. Same.
Yeah. You know, I got a nice message here in the mail. Who sent this to me? It's Gavin. Oh, beg your pardon, Graham. Graham says, Dave, I like to do good things in the world. So whenever I see a car with a ticket on the windshield, I chuck it in the garbage so the driver doesn't have to pay.
Oh, really?
Just curious, what acts of kindness do you do for strangers?
Kindness?
Graham.
Now they're paying double.
Warrant for their arrest.
Yeah.
This person read that and said, you know, people often forget the wet paint signs behind, so I regularly collect them and I hand them in to the lost and found. Here's more. Same goes for wet floor cones left in the middle of aisles. Someone could trip over those. Dave, when my neighbors put their garbage out in the evening, I take them straight back for them first thing in the morning so they don't get stolen in the middle of the night. I have found if I put my cat's litter or old milk out in my neighbor's garbage bins, especially on a hot day, it really helps keep the vagrants out of their garbage cans. This helps keep any financial or health records safe from prying eyes.
Yeah, what a nice courtesy.
Uh-huh.
These are things, nice things that people are doing here in the world.
Uh-huh, making it a better place.
I like it. I like people doing good things for others.
Mm-hmm.
Yes.
I help to keep their pets safe from the road until their owners come home from work and found that their garbage is the best place they can't escape from. So I put them in their garbage cans.
Their pet?
What? Yeah.
Oh.
So that they don't escape out into the roads and get hit by cars. Dave, whenever there's a meeting on a Friday afternoon, I like to ask lots of questions at the end so no one else feels embarrassed about the stony silence. Yes, hear, hear. One of my coworkers does this every meeting. The meeting always goes at least an hour over, and we're always so appreciative. I like to wait until my neighbors hang their washing out before I light the barbecue. That way the clothes block the smoke from spreading into their house. Also, I imagine it kills off bed bugs.
Do you know?
When I go to the gym, I leave all the free weights out, ready for the next person to pick up.
Oh, how thoughtful.
It's a little extra warm-up for them, re-racking my weights. I make sure to fill up the lowest spaces on the rack with all the lightest weights for any weak, short people as well. You don't like all these nice things that people are doing in the world?
Oh, they're delightful.
To make the world a sweeter place?
And not maddening at all.
I like to leave my left turn signal on at all times.
Get off the road.
To remind other road users what side of the road to drive on. This guy writes, good for you. I'm a BMW man myself. And these amazing cars have some bright, bright lights. So to avoid the risk of accidentally blinding the drivers around me, I simply make all turns without using any turn signals ever. At this point, I don't even know if they still work. But why take the risk at this point, eh? When I see a single mother struggling to pay at the bills, I offer to put the food back for them. Life must be hard enough for them without having to go around twice at the grocery store.
So thoughtful.
These are good people.
Really?
Whenever I'm sitting down on the bus and a frail little old lady boards the bus, I remain seated to enable her to build up her leg muscles. I'm truly a friend of the elderly. I've seen the same with heavily pregnant women. An ex-bus driver I used to know, would accelerate quickly and brake hard just to make sure that those people's reflexes were up to scratch. People helping out people. That's the kind of world I want to live in.
DSC on the KGB.
Whenever I notice someone has left their phone on the table at a bar or a cafe, I pop it into my bag and take it home so that it won't get stolen. I also like to do this with cash tips left behind on restaurant tables to make sure that the money doesn't end up in the wrong hands. These are good people doing good things to make the world a gooder place.
Yeah.
And you know, we're doing good things to make the world a gooder place.
Are we?
Yes, inflation compensation.
Oh, yes.
Makes the world gooder.
Mm-hmm.
Go to 101kgb.com and inflation compensation pops right up, right on the front there. It'll ask you, what is the nationwide keyword for this hour? And you just tell them, check. C-H-E-C-K, check. At 101kgb.com. Someone wins $1,000 right now. When you plug in that keyword for this hour, the 7 o'clock hour, we change it every hour. And right now it's check. Just like Ian does, he says, I check to make sure all the buttons are working when I exit an elevator.
Oh, God.
Huh?
Oh,
the remaining people in the elevator always look so angry, presumably because they're upset that they aren't going to get the credit for making sure that all the buttons work in the elevator. Huh? Not everyone can be as good as Ian. Good people making the world gooder. just like Def Leppard does, like Rocking You Now on the KGB. That's 50 years of rocking you with Def Leppard on 101.5 KGB San Diego. Thanks for switching us on this Monday morning. It's a gooder day this Monday because of good people. Mm-hmm. Good people that we heard about who started this whole segment by saying, you know, I see a parking ticket on someone's windshield. I quickly snatch it off and throw it in the garbage before they see it so that they don't have to suffer the indignity of having seen a parking ticket on their windshield.
Looking out for them.
There are more good people out there. This person says, if I walk into the bathroom and I see someone's in the stall, I bang on the door really loudly and ask him if everything's okay.
Check it out. Good.
Is everything okay? Do you need assistance? You know, that kind of human looking out for a human.
Mm-hmm.
We need more of that in the world.
Yeah.
I've recently started siphoning fuel from my neighbor's car to help them reduce their carbon footprint.
How thoughtful.
Earlier this morning, we were talking about the movie that I went to. I went to see that Crawdads, Where the Crawdad Sits Under a Tree.
Uh-huh.
And what's it called? I forget what it's called.
Where the Crawdads Sing.
Mm.
Tra-la-la.
I don't really recall that phrase being important in the movie.
Okay.
So it's one of those tricky movies. It's like, I don't know what the hell that means. Did it make sense in the book?
It was like a one-liner somewhere on someone's soliloquy, and it was like, okay, that's how you're going to call it? Okay.
Yeah, it doesn't mean anything.
No.
Like Star Wars.
Yeah.
You know what you're in for.
Yeah.
All right?
Got it.
You know what it is. A bunch of wars in the stars.
Got no book. Okay.
God help you. That's what they should name some of these movies, God Help You.
Yeah.
But we did go to the movies, enjoyed ourselves,
liked
the recliners, the whole thing.
Mm-hmm.
But I got this from Kyle, and he says, Dear Dave, I finally went and saw Top Gun over the weekend. Have we all seen it?
Yeah.
We've all seen
it. No, sir.
No, sir.
Boyer, go.
What's wrong with you, Boyer?
You need him to see it?
Boyer, you would enjoy it. You really would.
You know the guy to wait until it comes out?
He'll complain about it.
This is...
Wait.
No. We waited 2 years for it to come out.
Okay.
It's out. It took 2 years.
It's one you have to see in the theater. You
All
have
right.
to.
You know, there's no way the turbocharger will work at the Mach speed 10. Mm-hmm. He's going to complain about something.
Mm-hmm.
There's no Taiwan patch on his jacket.
Okay. Yeah, there is.
There is?
Yeah.
Fix that? Okay.
They said, China, we're doing it. They put
okay,
it on.
Good for them. Good
yeah.
for
America. Now I'll go see
now
it.
Now I'll go see it.
Yeah, that's what I was waiting for. God. You don't think I should wait till it comes out on that little wheel that you put in, the 3D Viewmaster? Should I watch it on a Viewmaster? Click. Click.
You have a mountain. Do you know how long you're going to have to wait for it to come in off the mountain?
A little while. Time is money.
Time is time. Money is money.
Okay.
What is he talking about? All right, never mind. I'm sorry I spoke to you. I finally went and saw Top Gun over the weekend. It was my first movie in the theater since well before the pandemic. And my word, does the social contract get violated in theaters these days? People had blankets. Some were in pajamas, and apparently now it's perfectly acceptable for people to either just put their stocking or bare feet on the seats during the movie. What the hell, Dave? Am I the only one disgusted by this? There's no way those seats are getting cleaned often enough for that kind of nastiness.
Mm.
Yeah, that's Kyle who has... You don't see this. You really don't run into this problem if you go into the high-end movie theaters that are recliners.
The problem of pajamas and blankets and stuff?
Pajamas and blankets are one thing, but he doesn't like the stocking and bare feet going up on the seats in front of him.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, the feet on the seats is a bug. But I like having a blanket at the theater.
I don't frankly see how a blanket bothers anybody.
It just makes me feel cozy.
Yeah. And if
and
you
those
wear
theaters are so cold.
They are. They are. I always dress warmly when we go.
Uh-huh.
Yeah. And people who wear pajamas, all right, you weirdos. I mean, I told you I was running into people in LAX wearing pajamas and Crocs. It's like they could barely get out of the house. You know, I'm in my pajamas. They're sleepwalking because they know the minute they get on their plane, they're going to fall into the coma that these airplane people had. They got pillows strapped to their bodies. They're narcoleptics who can barely make it through a flight without falling, lapsing into a semi-coma. Jesus. I hate people. But anyway.
Yes. Uh-huh.
The people with the socks and the bare feet up on the seats.
Yeah, I'm not so a fan uncool. of that.
I do that. But I do it on my own seat. I don't put my feet up on someone else's seat. But if I'm wearing my Birkenstocks, I'll just slip them off. And I do this all the time. And I put the recliner up and I put my bare feet up and I snuggle up and get comfy. Is that gross? I'm not doing it on the seat in front of me.
That's not a violation.
Good.
You're welcome.
I'm fine then. Okay.
I got a problem with Birkenstocks.
Well, I take them off.
You should take them off and put them in the garbage.
I shall never.
How does a glamour puss like you wear Birkenstocks?
They're a thing, David. They are.
They're a thing. That are ugly.
There are some ugly ones. I don't have the ugly ones. I have the cute ones.
Do they say Birkenstock on them?
Did they say it on them?
Yeah.
Somewhere on there.
Then they're ugly.
Dave.
They're no good looking Birkenstocks.
The white ones are cute. And then they have some with sparkles.
That's cute. Sparkles.
Very cute.
Sparkles.
Let's put some sparkles in the vomit and see if people think it's cute.
Draw more attention to them.
This time around. Yeah. I don't know. You're not home. You're not home.
No.
There is a certain amount of, I guess the last vestiges of I'm not home have just been thrown out.
Because we've been home for so long now. We're carrying it with us.
Poor little precious angel.
But they've also made the theater so damn cozy. You do want to, like, there's a snuggle in.
But you're not home.
But why did they make it so comfortable like home? They're creating that environment.
And the lights are off to enable you to do whatever you want.
Whatever you want.
Well,
okay.
You know, no, not like whatever, but kind of whatever.
Well, it's just leading to that.
Yes. There is a... Well, you know, you have to have some decency.
Hey, that girl took her shoes off. Why can't I take my pants off? It's what I do when I'm home.
That's why you brought the blanket.
It's why I'm cozy. Do you care if someone takes her pants off as long as they got a blanket over them?
God.
What?
Don't take your pants off.
Why? You're taking your shoes off.
We're
undressing, apparently. Who's deciding what's acceptable over there? You? I don't like your choice of what's acceptable because you can't even choose a decent shoe. Your taste cannot be trusted.
I would bet.
She went to the store and chose the ugliest shoes possible.
I got the cute ones. I would bet if you got no pants in there, you get no service.
I got a blanket over me.
No. Didn't we talk about blankets being creepy recently on the show? If you bring a blanket to a movie theater, wasn't that a red flag?
Emily just said that she brings a blanket with her to the movie theater.
That's right, because she's a girl. I think it's a guy thing. Guys, if you bring a blanket to the movie, unacceptable, weird, and creepy.
How sexist!
Yes.
Seriously, you're sexist, you're body partist.
How about I come to the movies with a man bun?
Oh, geez.
And I put my beard in a beard tail, you know, I put a little scrunchie around it.
Yeah.
In my Birkenstocks and a blanket.
Nice.
And I kick off my sandals and I put my blanket on and take off my pants under my blanket.
Probably have the theater to yourself. Everyone's out.
I don't see the problem in that, frankly.
It's good incentive.
So girls can bring a blanket to the theater, but guys can't?
Yes. Yes.
You see a guy bringing a blanket to the theater, you don't like it.
I don't like it.
That's a red flag?
What's going on under there? Girls are just getting cozy because we like to.
Guys can't get cozy?
Guys don't get cozy.
Guys are whacking under the blanket?
Guys don't get cozy in movies.
They're fiddling around down there?
You're up to no good.
Chainsaw, do you like a blanket when you're at home?
Not really. No.
Never.
No.
You never just sitting at home. It's like, oh, it's like it's winter. I want a blanket.
In my bed, yes. Yeah. Out in the front? No, not really.
Not in bed. Just in a chair.
Nah, not really.
Never ever. Okay. Nah. All right. So you're probably not down for bringing a blanket to the movies, are you?
No. Mm. No. That's strange, but I wouldn't be sexist about it. Yes, I would. Yes, yes, I would. That's weird, boys. Don't do it.
How intolerant.
I know.
And I tried to set up all kinds of good things, good people, making the world gooder today, and you just wipe it all out with your sexism.
Got a long way to go.
I suppose if you're a guy and you bring a blanket to the movie theater, you want them to drink at a different water fountain too, don't you, Mr. Exclusive?
Wow.
Well, thank you very much.
Maybe so. I don't want to drink in any water fountain.
All right, so that's no good, huh? Blanket's no good?
No.
Shoes off are okay?
Yeah.
I don't love it, but...
All right, well, Kyle was very upset. It's been a long time. He hasn't been to the movies in 2 years. Mm. Like, what kind of world have I woken up to?
It's an ugly place out here.
So if a guy brings a blanket to the movie theaters, he's beating off. That's what you say.
I mean, that's where it's going.
And Boyer says, if you see a woman with a large dog, she's having sex with him. That's the conclusions that you two draw.
Uh-oh.
You are...
Uh-oh, I don't like this.
That's where you are. You're in leap to jump to conclusion land, just like Boyer. Boyer's the mayor of jump to conclusion land.
Welcome.
I don't like being in this town.
If you see a girl bring a German Shepherd into the movies and puts a blanket over the two of them at the movie theater.
Oh, man. Woo! Run.
I'm just saying.
They're going to be squelching.
Undulating squelching.
Yes. Moistly.
All right, Chainsaw, what are we talking about in sports next?
Padres take on the Wall of Flushing. A not-so-routine fly ball, and more doing good things for other people.
By the way, we got a rock and roll threesome coming up here today.
Oh, wow, all right.
And I'm giving away 4 packs of tickets to SeaWorld. Ooh. All week. When's the last time you were at SeaWorld?
Pre-pandemic.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
You're overdue, lady.
I am.
Where would you take your son and try and convince him you're at SeaWorld? Was you take him outside and show him a puddle and tell him you're at SeaWorld? Is that what it was?
Oh. We went to the seafood section at the grocery store.
The seafood Oh, my God. I could see a pet store, fish tank, but the seafood section at the...
With the crabs and whatever.
You at least showed him the live animals, huh? Yes.
Okay. Yes. Here's a frozen cod.
Wow. These will be actual tickets to the actual SeaWorld.
Nice.
Not the lobster tank at Vaughn's. You see your friend on the grill over there? Hey, get ready for fun summer days and fiery summer nights at SeaWorld's Electric Ocean. Uh-oh.
Wait. That sounds dangerous.
Electricity and the ocean. Always a good combination. I'll tell you more about it when you win your 4-pack of tickets to SeaWorld coming up when we do the rock and roll threesome. Who's going to win it today? We'll find out. And Chainsaw Sports is going to be next year on the DSC show. More people doing good things to make the world a gooder place. Dave, I like to drive twice as fast as the posted speed limit. That way I'm on the road only half as much, and I cut the amount of accident potential in half.
Oh, okay. Clever analysis.
Man, this is making me feel cheerful on a depressing Monday. Good people doing good things. And now here's the Chainsaw Talking Sports on the KGB. Good morning. Well, good morning. It's Mike and David. And hello again, everybody in the sports world.
Could the Padres complete the three-game sweep yesterday in New York against the Mets, Bradley Cooper?
Yeah, that's not going to happen.
Aww. 2-1 to Alonso. Here's the pitch. Swing on a high fly ball. Well hit left center. He's on the way. And there it goes. A three-run homer for Pete Alonso. Over the Great Wall of Flushing to the right of
Great
the
Wall of Flushing.
Oh, as Pete Alonso lit this crowd here at Citi Field.
Sure.
His 25th home run of the year. The Mets are leading by a score of 3-1.
Whatever. Once down 8-1, the Padres scratched back to make it an 8-5 final. Now 54-43, the Padres are now 11.5 games behind the Dodgers in the division.
Goodbye.
Yeah. Let's focus on the wild card playoff spot the Padres have instead. Sitting pretty in the second of three spots by three games, Padres visit Detroit tonight through Wednesday. Detroit is in last place in their division with the fourth worst record in all of baseball. Such a forgotten team, people don't even remember their nickname.
I don't know. The Tiger Cubs?
No, it's just the Tigers. The Cubs are in Chicago. Padres Tigers first pitch 4:10 our time tonight. In Boston Friday night, the bases were loaded for Toronto's Raimel Tapia, who popped one up to deep center, but he knew it wasn't out of the park. He even cringed after he hit it, thinking it was a routine fly ball that would be caught. And
sends a drive to deep center, but where is it? And it's over, way over the head of Duran, who never saw it. He never saw it.
He never saw it.
Tapia around third, heading home. And inside the park, grand slam for Raimel Tapia.
Oh.
Boom!
The Blue Jays wound up beating the Red Sox at Fenway 28-5 that night. The most runs in the Red Sox have ever allowed at Fenway Park. The Blue Jays wound up sweeping all three games of the series, dropping the Red Sox to three games out of the American League wild card chase.
Oh, that was negative.
Yeah, but on the positive side, Toronto is three games up in the American League wild card chase. They're up! See? There's your positivity on a Monday. Meanwhile, in the National Valley.
You can't be done. You gotta live for the moment, man. You gotta keep a good attitude. That's why I hate being around negative people. You ever meet people like that? It's always the puss they have to.
This sucks. This blows. This sucks. Let's get out of here.
They could be in Times Square, New Year's Eve.
This sucks. Nobody's here.
I got friends like that. Not happy unless they're miserable. No matter how much good fortune comes away. Hey, you won the lottery, $40 million, that's great. Hell, they'll take a third in taxes.
Probably die before I'd see any of it.
What about the Mercedes you won in the raffle? I gotta get insurance. That's gonna cost me. You beat cancer, it'll come back. Probably lose an arm or leg next time. What a beautiful baby. It's a loser. It's already pants. What the hell's that all about?
Let's get a little association. Here's some more positivity. Former Laker forward Slava Medvedenko, who won two NBA championships during the Shaq and Kobe era, is auctioning off his two championship rings to benefit Ukrainian children in the war-torn Ukraine. Medvedenko said he realized, why do I need these rings if they're just sitting in my safe? So good for him. Going to fetch $100,000 or more. Chris Boyer did the same thing the other day when he said, why do I need this safe? I don't have anything in it. So he left it out on the curb where he leaves his other junk. Some guy threw his back out trying to lift it. But whatever. Did you at least give him the combination for it?
He's got it all.
Okay, you etched it on the safe.
Oh, right
good.
Out front.
Yeah, that's good. In other sports,
Dave. Dear Dave, I always get up early to mow my lawn at 6 a.m. on Saturday mornings. This inspires my neighbors, as it shows although it's the weekend, you can still be up and be productive. And then after I mow the lawn, I tip the clippings over my neighbor's fence. Their son's in jail for selling grass. I'm worried they can't get any. Plus, they get to wake up to the wonderful smell of freshly cut grass. See? Good people.
Yes.
Doing good things.
This is your 101.5 KGBFM Sports Network. Oh, my!
Dear Dave, whenever tourists ask me for directions, I point them in the opposite direction so that they can see more of San Diego. That's sweet. I'm cheered up.
KGB, home of the DSC.
All right, I need players for the rock and roll threesome. You can choose Amy, Chris Boyer, the Chainsaw, or nobody. It's been known to happen. Sometimes nobody wins the rock and roll threesome, so you got four choices there for the four-pack of tickets for SeaWorld coming up next. Dear Dave, I like to time how long my colleagues spend in the bathroom on cigarette breaks, etc., and then forward that to HR so they know how much time to deduct from their wages. It saves them the trouble of doing it, and I wouldn't want the guilt of accidental wage theft to weigh on their conscience.
A company person right there. That's good.
Dear Dave, whenever I see a "Have you seen this cat?" poster, I immediately call the number to let the owners know I have not.
Well, they asked the question.
Yes.
Dave, when a homeless person tells me they haven't eaten for days, I congratulate them on their self-control for dieting.
Gosh.
I do remind them cordially that no one likes a show-off, and I hope that they start investing more in their health, not just their showmanship. These are good people.
Yeah.
Doing good things to make the world a gooder place. And I'm glad that we saved this for a Monday.
Yeah.
It's a challenging time to come back to work. I want you to know that there are good people out there, and I hope it inspires you to be gooder for our world as well. All right, you ready for a rock and roll threesome?
Yeah. Well.
What's the matter?
I lost phones completely. Do you have any in there?
I got nothing but phones. Shall I do a little phone screen?
Yes.
Let me see. I don't do this.
I know.
This will be a real... Do you want to host the event and I'll screen it?
Sure. Like, you'll answer? Oh, wait, no. Wait, what?
I like how you agreed to it and then suddenly realized you had no idea what you just agreed to.
Uh-huh. Yeah.
We'll reverse roles here. I'll screen the calls, and then you can host the event.
Uh-huh.
You want to do that?
Sure.
All right. So let me start by screening. Hi, this is KGB. Do you want to play the rock and roll threesome?
I sure do.
Okay, what's your name?
Sean.
Sean. Spell that for me, Sean.
S-H-A-W-N.
All right. What number did Tony Gwynn wear on his jersey, Sean?
19.
Okay, so you're a guy. Hold on. All right, Sean's a guy. Okay. Well, it's that spelling that can't, you know, you can't always tell.
Yeah. Did you ask Sean who he wants?
See, it's my first time.
I know. I'm here,
Sean.
For you.
You'll make it through, Dave. Don't worry.
I'm trying. It's my first day. I'm a trainee. Sean, who would you like to choose? We have Emily, Chris Boyer, the Chainsaw, or nobody.
You know what? I'm going to go with Boyer.
All right. He said it with such glee. You know what? I'm going to go with Boyer.
All right, Sean. I'm going to put you on hold, and we'll let you know if you've won, okay?
Okay, thanks, Dave.
Hold on. Don't go away. Hi, you're on KGB. Would you like to play the Rock and Roll Threesome Contest?
Yes, sir, Dave. Good morning.
Hi, good morning. What's your name?
Joe. Yes, sir.
All right, Joe. Who would you like to choose to be your contestant?
Boyer.
Oh, I'm sorry. Chris Boyer, very popular contestant, has already been taken. I only have Emily and Chainsaw or nobody.
Nobody.
Joe, I think that's a smart... I think that's your only choice.
Yeah.
I think that's a smart choice and really the only choice. Yeah.
Can't argue with
Hold
it.
Hold on, Joe.
I agree.
Don't go All away.
Right. Emily might argue with it. I can't argue with it.
Hi, you're on KGB. Would you like to be on our rock and roll threesome contest?
Yes, I would.
And what is your name?
Gary.
Jerry.
Gary.
No, Gary.
Gary. Gary.
Gary.
Gary.
Matters.
Gary. Very good. Sorry, Gary. My bad.
God, how are we going to train you in this? I mean, come on.
It's my first day, man. Cut me some slack. Yeah.
Oh, well, when we lost, you know.
Are you a boy contestant or a girl contestant?
Come on, Dave. I'm all a
right.
guy.
All right. Who would you like to choose?
I think I'm going to have to do nobody today.
Sorry, nobody's already been taken.
Oh.
I have Emily or Chainsaw.
This hurts.
We'll do Chain. Chain's not even before.
Yeah.
Good morning, Chain. Right.
Good morning. Getty.
All right, hold on, Harry. And hi, you're on, whoops. Hi, you're on KGB. Would you like to play our contest?
I would love to.
And what is your name?
Cody.
Cody. And Cody, you are going to be thrilled with Emily as your contestant here today, okay?
Oh, goody.
Sincere or sarcasm?
Can't tell.
Sincere.
All right, very good. Okay. Cody, if you are to win, we're going to get... Oh, I'm sorry. That's not my part anymore.
Stay in your lane, David.
I'm just the screener. Beg your pardon.
That's all you are.
Stand by, Cody. Now let's turn it over to the host of the program. Here's Sarah with the Rock and Roll Threesome.
It's looking real good for Joe, who chose nobody. He could end up with a 4-pack of tickets to SeaWorld. Today we are doing a threesome to celebrate Geddy Lee's birthday week. Who can name where Geddy Lee is from? Or what band he's from?
Emily? Rush?
Yes.
Phew. That's right.
He is turning 69 this week. So I've compiled 3 Rush songs. I put them all together. It sounds absolutely hideous when we play them all at the same time. So whoever can buzz in first and name all 3 songs will win SeaWorld tickets for their player. I think that's it. Is that it? Did I miss anything?
I think you did good.
David, are you ready, sir?
Did you read the whole liner, though, about SeaWorld?
Well, I can.
That's your job. Let's get to it.
So it's 4-pack of tickets to SeaWorld to experience the electric ocean. Get ready.
Oh.
What? What is the look? What? What is with that look?
What are you talking about?
What?
What look? What are you talking about?
Man,
I didn't give you a look.
In that chair over there.
I didn't give you a look.
There was a look.
There was a look. I was just looking at you.
You were laying it on.
I was just looking at you.
Okay.
Okay, I won't look at the host.
Wow. One of those.
Man, you used some Botox in that chair. Get ready for fun summer days at Fiery Nuts at SeaWorld Electric Ocean.
What look?
Enjoy all new surprises this season from the rock and adrenaline stunt show and bioluminescent musical experience of Electro Blast to a thrilling lineup of live concerts at Bayside Amphitheater. You can experience every fresh moment of entertainment along with familiar favorites like our Club Seaglow DJ dance party, illuminating decor, and exhilarating street performances, plus nighttime fireworks. For more chances to win, you can log on to 101kgb.com/win. But if your player wins for you today, you're going to get a 4-pack now. Go.
Are you ready?
Yes.
All right. Get them all on yellow alert. Yellow alert. Sorry, yellow light. We're out of time.
No.
Can't play your little contest.
Time.
I don't want to go to a lot of meetings today. About how you can't make your time signatures and break on time for commercials.
Right,
you know, this
now,
is a business.
Cooking.
Wow.
Cookie? Oh, still me. Yes, sir. What is your guess?
Oh, okay. The only 3 songs I know. Tom Sawyer, The Spirit of Radio. Oh.
Boyer.
Chris Boyer.
Sarah, I'm going to guess Limelight, Spirit of Radio, New World Man.
Goodbye, Sean.
Oh, God, Sean, I'm so sorry. God.
May I hear it one more time?
Looking pretty good for Joe right now.
Easy.
Oh, is it now? Is it? Huh.
Yes.
Uh-huh. Convenient to say.
Yes.
I don't know any other thinking songs.
Three.
Emily.
Two. Emily.
Limelight.
Nice.
Spirit of Radio.
What?
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 Why did you do that?
What was your guess?
Limelight.
Yeah.
The Spirit of Radio.
No. Nice try. But no. It is The Spirit of Radio, which Chris Boyer screwed up on. It is Limelight and Free Will are your three songs by Rush. Some host you are ready to give it up.
Thank God for excellent producers to back us up. Right, David?
Well, we got a winner in Joe today. Joe is going to be our winner. So congratulations, Joe. You're going to get 4-packet tickets for SeaWorld. We're giving them away every day, all week. Experience the electric ocean. We got more chances to win when you go to 101KGB.com.
DSC on the KGB.
All right, here is your inflation compensation keyword. Bills, B-I-L-L-S. You just go to 101KGB.com. Inflation compensation comes right up in the front there. It's going to ask you, what's the keyword for this hour? Because we do change it every single hour. Now we're in the 8 o'clock, and the word you want to plug in is Bills, B-I-L-L-S. Enter it now at 101KGB.com because someone is going to win $1,000 here in inflation compensation. Dear Dave, if I had known I could bring a blanket to a movie theater, I might not have gotten caught jerking it. Signed, Pee Wee Herman.
See?
Dear Dave, the real reason NASA doesn't want the astronauts punching the clown in space is because they don't need to turn the space station into a snow globe. Love your show. That's Tim checking in. Emily's going to have the real, I guess, all the gripping details about astronauts jerking it in space, right?
Just why it's frowned upon.
It's frowned.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
Dear Dave, I don't wash my feet for weeks before I go to the movies, so other people will not be self-conscious about their dirty old sock smell. Okay. Signed, good person doing good things.
Yes.
Dear Dave, I don't like to be greedy or selfish. I always leave one generous sip in the milk carton or the orange juice container for the next person. Ooh. Signed, good people. Dear Dave, whenever asked by the homeless if I have any spare change, I always stop, check my pockets, and say, well, yes, I do. I usually show them the change, too, just in case they think I'm lying, before putting it back in my pocket and going about my day. Dear Dave, if I see someone going up a ladder onto a roof, I always wait for them to get up there, and then I take the ladder down and put it away. Safety first. These are good people.
Yeah.
Dear Dave, when I see a person staring at the canal, I give them a gentle nudge into the water. I know they're trying to build up the courage to jump in, so I save them the few minutes of dithering. Also, with the heat these days, it's nice to help people cool off. Dave, whenever I see homeless people begging for change, I politely inform them that they can get all the money they want simply by having a job.
Aww.
Huh? What's the matter?
Whew, the balls.
Dave, when I'm in the elevator and I see someone with loads of bags hurrying towards me, I hammer the closed door button so they can have the next one all to themselves. Isn't it good to know that there are these good people out there in the world?
Mm-hmm.
When I'm shopping, I like to move some of the frozen and refrigerated items onto the regular shelves so others don't have to walk so far to find what they need. It also means they don't have to wait for their chicken to defrost and put it straight into the oven when they get home. I like it. I think these people are awfully helpful, don't you?
Yes. Yep. So thoughtful.
You know, I saw that One of the stars from the Elvis movie died.
Yeah.
Did you see that?
I did see that headline.
A very young person, too.
Yeah.
Very surprising.
Mm-hmm.
I've not seen the Elvis movie, despite the fact that it's getting great reviews and the trailer does look great for it.
Yeah.
But I was told when we were going to the movies this weekend, she did not want to see the Elvis movie. So that's why we had to go see the Crawdads thing.
Is there a reason she didn't want to? Or
I guess it doesn't appeal to her.
Okay.
The whole Elvis thing is not going to necessarily appeal to everybody. But the question came out at the Elvis movie. Did the actor who played Elvis sing in the movie?
Mm.
And I've got this whole list of singing movies. And I will ask you, did the actor actually sing in the movie or not?
Okay.
How about the Elvis?
I like this. Yeah. Yes.
You all agree with that?
Oh, yeah. Yeah.
Yeah.
Sort of.
Aww. Oh, no.
Mm-hmm. It's a blend. Austin Butler did a blending singing with Elvis.
Huh.
So sort of yes, but not completely.
Okay.
How about Jennifer Lopez for Selena?
Yes.
Yeah.
Yeah.
No.
Boyer, do you know what Jennifer Lopez does for a living?
She sings.
Yeah.
Pretty well, but I don't know that she could pull off a Selena. So I'm going to say no.
You're familiar with Selena music quite intimately.
Can you name one Selena hit? No.
No. Everyone else said yes. I wanted to be different.
Uh-huh.
And you are correct.
Ooh, what? Yeah.
He's right.
Man. Surprising.
He's right. She lip-synced through the whole thing.
Huh.
Mm-hmm. How about Andrew Garfield? Learning to, who cares about that one?
Nobody.
Yeah, no way.
Thank you.
Nope.
You're saying no?
No.
I would have said yes.
He's a regular listener. Sorry, Andy.
He doesn't look like a singer.
I feel like he's a theater guy. And
he sang and played piano.
What? Yeah.
He sang and played piano.
For who? I forget.
Tick, tick, boop.
Oh.
How about Bradley Cooper for A Star is Born?
Yes.
Yeah. Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Chris Boyer just going to agree with everyone?
Yes, this time, yes.
Yeah, he did. He famously sang that, I think, at the Grammy Awards, didn't he?
Yeah.
Yeah. Worked with a vocal coach, the whole thing. How about Rami Malek for Bohemian Rhapsody playing Freddie Mercury?
No way.
Could that one be a blend like the Elvis?
They
cheated it?
You can guess. He sang, he didn't sing, or he blended?
He blended.
He sang.
No, he didn't.
He didn't.
No.
No, he did not sing. Mm. Lip syncing all the way. In fact, he joked, no one wants to hear me sing. How about George Clooney in Oh, Brother, Where Art Thou?
Yeah.
I'll go yes.
Yes.
I didn't see it. Sure.
It's a Coen Brothers. I think it's a Coen Brothers movie, isn't
Sounds
it?
Right.
Yes.
Yeah. And I think it's set like in the 1930s, and there's a lot of real hillbilly country music.
He's got a good speaking voice.
No, he doesn't.
I bet he could sing.
No.
Yeah, he does. So he does not sing?
He does not sing.
Oh.
No, he did not sing.
Of course not.
No, really? No.
What are you thinking?
No.
Hello.
No, no, and no.
Huh.
How about Zac Efron in High School Musical?
No way.
Yes.
Yes.
Yes, no. He did. Stay and sing more.
Boyer?
No, sir.
He's tippy-tappy with the song in his heart.
Who is?
Zac Efron.
What does that mean?
He likes to sing and dance.
He's just got the music in him?
Mm-hmm.
Doesn't mean he does it well.
Yes, he does. You don't even know.
Wah.
Does it get you upset to hear people picking on Zac Efron?
He's so great.
Oh, he's got a great torso.
He's darling.
Zac Efron did not sing in High School Musical.
No way. There's no way.
I don't believe your list.
No. Wah. Bunk list.
Wah. Mm-hmm. Get it out.
That's one way to cope in today's world, is just to say, I don't believe it.
Yep.
No singing for Zac Efron. He did do all of his own singing in High School Musical 2. And 3, and Hairspray and The Greatest Showman, but not in the original High School Musical. Sorry.
Wow. Trick question, man.
Well, I was actually quite specific with my wording. How about about Jamie Foxx in the movie Ray?
Blend.
He sang.
No.
He sang.
So Emily says yes. Chainsaw says yes. Sarah, what'd you say?
I said it was a blend.
I said no.
No. He did not sing in Ray. Lip synced all the way. No singing. How about Taron Egerton in Rocket Man, the Elton John?
Yes. He blended.
Oh, now, wait a minute. Yes, he sort of sang. What do you think, Chainsaw?
No.
Did you see Rocket Man?
No. I did not.
Sarah.
He totally sang, and I did not see it, but he totally sang.
Bort.
No.
How could anyone sing for Elton John?
Come on. Right.
He sang every note.
Get out of here.
Every note.
Wow.
How about Reese Witherspoon for Walk the Line? That's the Johnny and June Carter Cash movie.
Sure.
Yeah, she did. Yeah.
I think that was an Academy Award for her.
Yes, yeah. She did.
Who's saying yes?
Sarah.
Cookie.
I did.
Yeah.
No.
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 Why no?
I don't know. She just, I don't think.
Sang every line.
She was great in that. And she did it in front of live audiences. Very impressive.
How about Natalie Wood in West Side Story?
No.
What? I don't know. Maria didn't sing her own lines in West Side Story?
No.
You can't look
she
that good and
then.
Sing. No.
Sure.
No.
Yes.
It's impossible.
Natalie Wood, come on. She was there for hotness, not for singing. She didn't sing a damn thing in West Side Story. Get real, people.
Seriously.
How about Tom Cruise in Rock of Ages?
Yes. I can't see Tom wanting a stunt double for anything.
Tom Cruise, Rock of Ages.
Yes.
Yeah.
Yes.
He did his own.
All four saying yes?
He did his own cursing, too.
Come on, Blair. You saw the movie.
Okay, what do you mean?
No, that's the other movie.
That's the other movie. Sorry. But I'm going to say he did.
Yes. What are you doing over there?
I don't know.
Okay.
Mixing up movies, yeah.
Boyer say no?
Yeah.
You're wrong.
Shoot.
There isn't anything Tom Cruise doesn't do.
Right. And you saw that movie with us in the theater.
His own stunt singing.
Excuse me? What's this now?
Yeah.
Boyer went to see Rock of Ages?
In the theater.
Bless your heart. You went to the theater. You won't see Maverick, but you'll see a thong thing and dance.
It was free.
So I was sitting at home.
There was a girl.
Oh. Enough said. How about Christopher Plummer singing Edelweiss or any of the other songs in The Sound of Music? The Captain, where he sings Edelweiss at the end there. Did he sing that or not?
No.
Yes. I bet he was like theater trained, one of those guys.
Yeah.
Back in the day.
I think you're right.
No.
What?
I bet he's not. I bet he's not. How about no? That's a big negative. No, he didn't sing that one. And then how about Britney Spears in Crossroads?
Of course she did. It's her voice. She's saying everything. It's her voice. Shut up. Shut up. Everything she does is her voice.
Every other time.
Shut up. Yes, she did.
Millie Vanilli sang on that.
No, she didn't. She's saying it. It's her voice. And your stupid Liz is going to try and twist it as wrong if it says it's no. It is.
Is it a blend?
Yes, she did.
Your sister said.
Blend.
Did you say Jamie's?
Yes.
How about the dad son?
Her one of her exes. Yeah.
Yes.
Isn't Jamie the dad's name?
Yes.
Uh-huh. Jamie Lynn's the sister.
Who's the dad?
Jamie.
Yeah. So who are you saying? The sister or the dad sang?
Both. It was a blend. The sister and the dad did a blend.
Britney Spears actually sang every line in Crossroads. You? And they believe that is the reason it scored 14%. Because she insisted on doing her own singing. Too bad. And here's a guy who's been on our show and sang all his own lines in School of Rock. Here's Jack Black on the KGB. That's our friend Jack Black singing his actual lines. Had him on a couple weeks ago getting ready for Comic-Con. I did not see him skulking around Comic-Con, as he likes to do.
Yeah.
He likes to just walk around in broad daylight in a Stormtrooper outfit. He called me out when we had him on the show.
Yeah, he did.
Because someone tattled.
Yes, they did.
Said that I doubted he was a genius. But I guess he actually won some award from MTV that said he's a genius.
Comedic genius, yeah.
So I stand corrected. But we're going to have a couple of words about the tattling on this show.
Tattling right. Tourette's, I couldn't help it.
What was it? Tattling Tourette's?
Yeah, it just came out.
I don't like that at all. Chainsaw is going to talk sports with us next year, and what are we hitting?
Padres, okay. What about Bernie Tatis, okay?
Okay.
Encouraging health news and money.
He's feeling better? Bernie?
Yeah.
Good.
Yeah.
The DSC streaming on your smart device.
101.5 KGB.
Dear Dave, I'm a good person. Whenever I'm on a nearly empty bus or train late at night, I always make sure to sit right next to a lone woman so she feels safe and protected by me. I'm 6'3" and 300 pounds.
Oh, my God.
I also make sure to follow her home and stand in her yard, staring through the windows to make sure that she gets back in safe and sound.
It's a hero.
Good people doing good things.
Yeah.
It's heartwarming, really.
To make it a gooder place. And they all listen to the Dean of American Sportscasters, the Chainsaw, doing sports right now on the KGB. Good morning.
Welcome on again. Thank you, David. And hello again, everybody in the sports world. Could the Padres complete the three-game sweep yesterday in New York against the Mets?
No.
Okay, well, that's a spoiler. You know,
2-1 to Alonso. Okay. Right. Here's the pitch. Swing on a high fly ball. Well hit. Left center.
He's
on the way. And there it goes. A three-run homer for Pete Alonso over the Great Wall of Flushing.
The Great Wall of Flushing. I hear you can see it from space.
Oh, it's Pete Alonso at this crowd here at Citi Field. His 25th home run of the year. The Mets are leading by a score of 3-1.
Once down 8-1, the Padres scratched back to make it an 8-5 final. Now 54-43 on the season. The Padres are now 11 and a half games behind the division-leading Dodgers. So
I don't want to hear that.
I'm sorry?
I don't want to hear that.
All right, then. Let's focus on the wild-card playoff spot the Padres have, sitting pretty in the second of three spots by three games. Padres visit the Detroit Tigers tonight through Wednesday. Another chance for the Padres to gain revenge against the team that clobbered them 4-1 in the 1984 World Series. So obviously that's on the top of mind for all the current players, many of whose parents were in grade school in foreign countries when that happened way back then. So, yeah, they're thinking
you're
about
stupid.
It. Padres-Tigers first pitch 4:10 our time tonight. And what about superstar shortstop Fernando Tatis Jr.?
What about him?
Well, he broke his wrist falling off a motorcycle, last December and hasn't played a single inning since. He was supposed to be back in the lineup last weekend. That's what they told us like a month ago, man. But he's swinging the bat now, and his return is anticipated in the coming weeks. Plural weeks. The season ends in 10 weeks.
What?
Either way.
What?
He still gets paid the entire $340 million on his contract guarantee. So perhaps cliff diving or rugby would be good activities for him this next coming offseason.
Somebody didn't tell you when you need to shut up.
Yeah. In health news, President Biden's COVID-19 symptoms now include a sore throat and body aches. And this is interesting. Both symptoms have a higher approval rating than he does.
And, good for them.
Yeah. And on the flip side, Steve Bannon was convicted for contempt of Congress and now faces prison, which means he'd finally have a good excuse for not showering.
Not funny. And disgusting.
Oh, okay. I'm just covering both sides, Mr. President. I'm sorry. Meanwhile, in the national bath.
I woke up this morning in the hotel, and I couldn't figure out how to work the shower. That's humiliating. You're just standing there, naked, confused. If finally just give up and take a bath. There's no reason a grown man should be taking a bath. Every time I take a bath, I'm worried somebody's gonna walk in and be like, oh, Greg decided to kill himself. Aren't you gonna try and stop me? No, no, you're a grown man taking a bath. Things must be pretty bad. The shower had 8 different settings. 8. You could pick whichever one you wanted. Problem is, only one of them made any sense at all. It's like, yeah, I want the one where the water comes out and hits me. Not the 2 lasers going off to the side. Not massage. I don't know what massage is supposed to feel like, but I don't think it's a camel spitting on you every 7 seconds. They're not real choices. It doesn't matter how many you have. It's like going to the ice cream store. Yeah, we got 100 flavors. We got chocolate, bacon, motor oil, Anvil, cigarette lighter, Marshall Tucker Band, whatever you want.
Basketball Association. Okay. Superstar Kevin Durant wants out of Brooklyn, and now finals runner-up Boston has entered discussions for him. The 33-year-old Durant has 4 years and $198 million left on his contract. Wait, what? Yes, that's, if I have this right, $49.5 million a year. Wow. Turns out Fernie Tatis is working cheap. Working? In other sports, David.
Dear Dave, whenever I see a mother breastfeeding in public, I make sure to stare directly at her for a good few minutes in order to signal to her that I am comfortable with her partial nudity. This, of course, prevents her from feeling self-conscious. I'm good people. Oh, this is, we got to do this every Monday.
This is wonderful.
This is so great.
So warm. All right. It is.
8:33 and 42 seconds, and this is your
101.5 KGBFM Sports Network.
Oh, my.
Dear Dave, whenever someone tells me they've lost something, I remind them to remember where they left it. I offer a helpful prompt, such as, where did you see it last? Or, have you tried looking for it? Dear Dave, I crank up the office air conditioning to full and open all the windows to try and help fight global warming. Oh, wow.
Nice. Very nice.
I am thoroughly cheered up.
Yeah.
The DSC is streaming on your smart device. 101.5.
Dear Dave, when I'm in the checkout at the grocery store and I've got a massive cart full of shopping, I always ask the guy behind me, and all he's got is a loaf of bread. I say, is that all you got? And he says, yes. I always say, whew, boy, you're going to be a long time because I'm going to be here forever. I call myself the time saver.
Sure.
Dear Dave, when the neighbor's kids send a ball over my fence, I always throw it in the other direction into the other neighbor's yard. It makes the kids think they are stronger than they thought and boosts their self-esteem. Dear Dave, whenever I'm in line for a cash machine, I like to give the person in front of me a gentle kiss on the back of the neck so they know I'm not a threat.
What?
Wow. Very affectionate and considerate. Yes, when you think about it.
These are good people doing good things to make the world a gooder place. No doubt you agree. Listen to this email I got from Erica over the weekend. Dear Dave, I discovered over a cup of coffee with my boyfriend's mom that he is sharing intimate details of our sex life with her. Ooh. Don't you girls like to talk about that stuff?
Mm-mm. With our girlfriends?
Really?
Yeah. Okay. Not with the mom.
That news to you?
I guess not. I don't know. I guess guys do it, girls do it too, yep. Right? Okay.
She even mentioned the exact position we were in and added, I hear it didn't go so well.
Oh, God.
Uh-oh.
Oh, God.
Who does this? I quickly ended the conversation and immediately went to my boyfriend to find out what that was all about. He acted like it was no big deal. He added, many sons talk to their moms about their sex life. He told me that he and his mom are very close and they tell each other everything. I'm not stupid. I know it isn't normal and that my boyfriend of a year told his mom about our sex life is not right. But I have to know, if you guys know of any other guys who do this, because I'm thinking this is a break-upable issue. How the hell do I get him understand he needs to knock this off? Haven't you been, you've been encountered, haven't you?
But different scenario. The mother-in-law just wanted to know private, intimate details and flat out asked. And then she was shut down.
By you?
By me, by her husband, by my husband.
I see.
Everyone else was but horrified she was asking.
But she had no problem bringing it up to you.
She said, we're family. We share things.
So this is a thing.
Yeah. But I say the fact that this guy.
But you didn't participate.
No.
Much.
Other than to try to pass it off to my husband to deal with. And then. What?
Did he answer any questions?
No, he got angry that she was asking.
Oh. Okay. So what do you think about this?
Red flag. Whoop, whoop. He's never going to change. Run away. Cut bait.
Wow. I remember when you used to try to work things out with people.
Yeah.
Now it's just.
Life's too short.
Just run that knife across the throat and call it done.
I'm thinking back to a story we heard recently. Someone wrote to us telling us how the mother-in-law had put a hidden camera in the bedroom because the wife wasn't taking good care of her son. That is your future. This guy's always going to side with his mom. The mom's always going to butt her nose into your business. Bail. You're not married yet. You can still get out.
Right. All right. Emily doesn't like it. What about you, Chainsaw?
Okay. So this is the girlfriend's boyfriend who's talking with his mom about their
sex life.
That is just a red flag. I'm out. Get out. They've been doing this forever. You can't break that habit.
Right. You're not going to change him.
You're not going to change him without a lot of pain. And
you're not going to change him.
Exactly. And all you're going to get is pain. So right. Out. Get out. Get out. No.
Unless you have no problem with your mother-in-law knowing every intimate detail about your life.
Why would you? Well, what's the what? No, seriously. If you found the right person. Mm-hmm. If you found the right person, the one, who cares if your mother-in-law knows? Well, what damage does it do to you?
Total.
What?
It cancels out the right person factor.
Explain why to me.
Mommy, Oedipus, it's just weird. And it's obviously a problem for her, otherwise she wouldn't be writing in. Mm-hmm.
I understand that, but sometimes people need to explain why it's a problem. And when they can't, then they realize, maybe it's not a problem. Maybe I thought it was, and then I actually thought about it for a minute, and I realized, well, what does it do? Nothing. They want to talk about it. Who cares? Because after all, I will talk about this with my girlfriends.
Yeah.
It's not like a secret that must not be heard by other ears. It will be heard by other ears. I just don't want those ears to hear it. Well, why is
that?
What difference does it make?
Well, I think in every life, you hold a couple of cards where you don't have to explain and you can just say, because it just is. And this is the one. I guess I can't explain it other than it's, I can't explain.
There's a dynamic with parents and kids that are different than amongst friends.
It's different.
With the guy with his guy friends and the girl with her girlfriends.
And Emily, how is it different?
It just is.
There's a power dynamic. There's a relationship intimacy thing that sharing with your peers.
Not with him, there isn't.
Yeah, he's determined that his mom is his BFF, and that's who he wants to confide in.
It's perfectly normal for him to talk about this with his mom, and it was perfectly normal for your mom or mother-in-law. Who was it?
My mother-in-law.
Mother-in-law to have the discussion about it. So it's out there. That feeling is out there.
Yeah, to me, it also indicates, though, his mom is always going to be his number one. And if you want to be that number one in your husband's life, that's not with this guy. There's too much history with him and his mom and a closeness that you're just never going to be able to rival.
Seems like a wild jump, but whatever. Sarah, what do you think about this?
I wouldn't run away immediately. I would stop sex and be like, until you change, like, you're getting nothing. I'm not going to break up with him over it
That'll
yet.
That'll work.
He's going to run to his mom and say she's cut off sex.
I'm going to give him the chance to hear me and realize, okay, if you don't realize this is a freaking boundary, hello, this is a boundary. You cannot cross this with me anymore. Stop it. Knock it off.
Well, he can't just do it to please you. He's got to convert.
Convert to what?
Convert to the understanding that this is weird, yeah, man.
So that's why if he obviously doesn't
weird
get that,
to you, know sir.
Yes, sir, sir. Very weird to me, sir.
So you lay down your law, which you didn't think you had to lay down before, but now you know. Hello.
Haven't you guys ever discovered something when you moved in with or married someone? It's like, oh, I didn't know that about you. Okay, I can't behave that way anymore. Or the way you behave is going to have to be my new normal. I did.
And usually for me, that was like self-improvement where I needed to clean up my act. You know?
Yeah, but you're not down for it on this case, I guess, huh?
No.
I like that attitude, but of course, none of your opinions matter. Mm-mm. All that matters is what Chris Boyer thinks about this. And he'll just say the exact same thing Sarah said to try to impress her.
Well, maybe not. Actually, I think the mother could be helpful. Oh, I think the mother has more experience. You know, our emailer wrote about a particularly failed attempt in a certain position, and maybe mom could offer the son some coaching and some background.
Who are you?
Tell him maybe a better, more effective way to get it done. Maybe a little more lube.
Is that what you and your mom do?
No, but...
Would you be down for that?
No, but my dad and I would have talked about it.
You and your dad would talk about your sex life?
Well, I mean, occasionally.
How about you, Chainsaw? You and your dad talk about your sex
life? Oh, God. I mean, no.
I heard you shriek no.
No.
You're not going to talk about your sex life and positions and...
Oh, God.
Various lubes with your dad like Boyer did.
I mean, my dad would have just spit on it first, but now we have the glory of... heating, warming lubricants and things.
We didn't
of that
have
nature.
Lube in your dad's day. When was he born? The 1400s? Jeez, they had 30s. Oil then. They were dropping it on the soldiers down below. Come on. You would not talk to your dad about your sex life. Did you ever?
Yes.
One time?
Really? A couple of times. He talked about one time he was teaching college and his students at the end of the year gave him a joint. So he and his girlfriend smoked half of it. And my dad got hot sweats and had to go into the shower. The next night they smoked the second half and he had to fall asleep. And then the third night he said, screw it, I'm going back to beer. And he drilled it home with a girlfriend. So that was a little bit of good advice. Don't smoke the dope if you're planning on getting laid. None of the jazz cabbage.
I don't really
son.
See that as a discussion about your sex life.
That's a no to drugs, it sounds like, more than anything else.
Was that it? Was that the total discussion about your sex life with your father?
We talked about how he used to go to his dad's automotive repair shop in the middle of winter.
Sexy place.
And push the car into the service bay and turn on the heater and bang the chicks there. And my grandfather could never understand why he had a high heating bill when he never turned the heater on. So there's just some good advice for youngsters starting out in the backs of cars.
Good advice.
Okay, so Boyer has... detailed for us how he and his parent would have discussions about their sex life.
But daddy is a little different than mommy.
Oh, my. Here we got another sexist on the show.
I know.
Here we go.
I know.
Anyone want to be the racist for today? Anybody? Who wants to be the homophobe?
Not me.
Not me. What if daddy is no longer available?
Yeah,
mom may be maybe a single parent situation.
I'm sure you'll be talking about that at Thanksgiving.
And we have had for hundreds of years times where the consummation of the marriage is witnessed by the parents.
Easy.
Okay.
Easy. You think that's still going on?
In some cultures, yes. I think that there are all sorts of things happening around the world.
Hang on. Let me check. Let me check something. P.S. Dave, I'm writing from the United States of America.
That doesn't mean they're not immigrants.
P.S. Dave, we were born and raised in the United States of America.
Let me see your papers.
Old world traditions.
All right. Well, a split decision here, Erica. I know that you thought this was going to be an easy way out. Emily and Chainsaw agree with you that it's a red flag, but Sarah says give him a chance before you take off. And Chris Boyer sounds like he is 100% into it. Well, he's the one here with experience of talking sex life with his parents.
That's true.
It could be very helpful. Very helpful. Just think of the guidance and the years of experience that your mom has who might be able to give you a good system for driving at home or not firing too early.
What was the bit we used to do where we would we would have women call up, and they would have to make a prediction. Who?
How many guys have put the stuff into you?
No, yeah. No. Oh, well, it was awesome. They was that what it was? We had to figure out who was getting more action, the daughter or the mom. I guess it was how many guys have put the stuff into you.
Yeah.
Was that the bit?
Yeah, and you'd have to predict how many partners mom had had.
Yeah, and these women would call up and say, oh, my mom is way more than me. You remember that?
Mm-hmm. Oh, yeah.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
And they usually were.
The moms were?
The moms were, yeah. Like welcoming home an entire brigade from war.
Huh. I don't have the same memory as you. Of course, you have no reliable memory whatsoever. So.
Airtight mommies. That was the...
Oh, my God.
That numerous
we did run into a couple of those, didn't we?
Yeah.
Yeah, we did. Yeah. Was that one of my new bands?
I don't know.
The Airtight Mommies?
We could make it one.
All right.
I shall.
Do it.
I'll make it out of it, David.
All right. What's coming up in our Happy Crackpot News next year? Emily.
We are going to talk about mumble mouths.
Mumble mouths.
Mm-hmm. Those dang mumblers. Some crazy concert shenanigans over the weekend. Mm. And animals gone wild.
Yeah, if you were at a concert and you were told there's a tornado in the area, would you riot because they canceled the concert?
Yeah, stick around and riot, yeah.
Be out of there so quick. Big problem for the Kid Rock concert in North Dakota. We'll tell you all about that and all the crackpot news next.
The home of the DSC.
Hey, Alexa, play 101.5 KGB from iHeartRadio.
Listen to this. Dear Dave, did you get that stack of ones we sent to Chris Boyer? It's just a little help for his analogies because we like to help with your little radio bits because we're good people doing good things, making the world gooder. Signed, Honest Family. Dear Dave, when my friends are traveling by air, I like to give everyone's feelings of security by telling them, I hope your plane doesn't crash. Mm-hmm. For some inexplicable reason, certain people bristle at such well-wishing, so I simply say, okay, I hope it does. Then everyone's happy. Love your show. And Yavel, and that's Quiet Talking James checking in. Look at all these good people.
Yeah.
Dear Dave, whenever my dog poops on the ground, I cover it with leaves so people don't have to look at it.
So thoughtful.
Dear Dave, I always keep one hand down my pants to keep it warm and ready for any handshakes I might have to do when meeting new people. Dear Dave, whenever I see a young woman looking sad or fed up, I always tell her that she looks so much prettier if she just smiled. It's a small thing, but it fills them with joy to know that they can make themselves more attractive to random men on the street with so little effort. In a joyous world we live in. Oh, hey, I didn't give you your inflation compensation keyword. Should we make this the top story?
Yes, please.
It's 9 o'clock now here. We've got a new word for you to win $1,000. We'll be doing this all day today, all week. Keyword for this hour is pay. That's P-A-Y. So when you go to 101kgb.com, inflation compensation will come right up on the front page there. And it will ask you, what is the nationwide keyword? You know it for this hour. It's pay, P-A-Y. And you know what you get for that.
Money, money, money.
$1,000 worth of money, money, money.
Yeah.
All right, Emily, what's kicking off our crackpot news for today?
Well, I learned this morning that astronauts have been warned against masturbating in space over fears that female astronauts could get impregnated by stray fluids.
Rogue runaway sperm?
Uh-huh. What? Uh-huh.
Now, what? I could see this. I could see this.
You,
mm-hmm.
I mean, mm-hmm.
You got some female astronaut doing naked yoga.
Right.
Uh-huh. Doing a lot of stretching.
Uh-huh.
And some other guy is just shot putty at the moon.
Right.
Or in its general direction. You never know. Mm-hmm. You just never know.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. There are strict guidelines over alone time, and scientists have been warned that even the slightest rogue droplet could cause chaos on board.
What's the matter?
Because I know we're all very unsure of how it works down there, of like what goes on down there. I don't think you can just be like opening your legs or sit on some stuff and it gets sucked up in there to make a baby. I just don't think that can happen.
happened.
What do you mean we're all very unsure of how things work down there? What do you mean by that?
None of us know what goes on.
Right.
On a woman, not sure the equator. I don't know what's down there.
We do admit and have talked regularly about how guys have no idea what's going on down there mm-hmm. with you girls.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
It's just, we don't believe that you know about your own bodies either.
We don't.
But I just found out a few days ago that women have the same mystery about men. Very little. In fact, they're very surprised to hear how that stuff works.
Totally.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Do you feel that way?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
I guess you keep it a little bit more quiet than we do.
So. Maybe. We don't want to seem uncool.
Yeah, I get it.
Yeah.
Totally get it. Uh-huh. You know, ignorance is not always charming, is it?
Yeah, just keep your mouth shut.
Yeah. Any particular question that you have that you've been walking around with going, I just don't get how works?
It is weird to me since I'm still not always have to be in the bathroom with my 4-year-old.
Mm.
But if the pee-pee's pointing down, why does the pee go down? It still goes up like a freaking rainbow.
Yeah.
That makes no sense.
Yeah. It's not a perfect nozzle.
Mm-hmm.
Mm-mm. It just isn't. You're going to have to talk to the big man upstairs about that. We're not happy about that either. We're just no longer. I mean, I shouldn't even say we're not surprised by it. It's still surprising to us. When you have the double stream go and neither one is going the straight ahead, you got one going hard left, one going hard right. You don't know what to do.
Whoa.
Yeah. Yikes. It can happen. Yeah, I know. It's messed up.
Sounds messy.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Well, fortunately, we have moms and wives to take care of that for us.
And do that to make the world gooder, to make us feel like we have purpose.
Yeah. Women will get upset about that. It's like, how come you just can't aim straight? It's like, because I think you still aren't. It's not that you don't understand. You don't want to understand or don't want to hear it. They don't always go straight.
This is why I'm all for men sitting down when they pee. Sit down.
Wow.
Point it down. Hold
Boyer,
it down.
Boyer sits. He's a sitter.
Yeah, I know. I'm totally for this. If you're at home and you don't have a urinal, sit down.
Boyer does. He sits down at home. Even if he's not wearing a skirt that day, he sits down to pee,
good
doesn't
boy.
He?
I sure do. Mm-hmm. I mean, unless I'm in the backyard. That would be odd.
You don't squat in the backyard?
I don't squat in the backyard. No.
Why is that? I thought you sat down. Why do you sit down?
To avoid the random spray and in case I'm inspired to do more.
In case you decide to do more work?
Yeah. It's like, well, you know, while I'm here.
Understood. Oh. Understood. All right. Anything else that you want to know? That's a biggie. It's probably number one on the list. We don't get it either. But, you know, we didn't invent it.
Mm-hmm.
Take it up with the designer. Because we got a question for him, too. How come you put the intake so close to the output?
Yep.
Not real happy about that, but whatever. Awfully close, don't you think?
Yeah. Oh.
Uh-huh. I mean, man.
Mm-hmm.
Hoy, yoy, yoy. Mm-hmm. In broad daylight, both of you stone cold sober, it's challenging enough.
Yeah.
Now you put it at night in a bottle of tequila later. Accidents will happen. Mm. There's no question about that.
Mm.
Vicky Sue Horpants knows what I'm talking about. Okay, what else?
Well, still talking about sex and space. There's an astronomer, Dr. John Millis, who says that sex and masturbation in space are...
What is it?
Masturbation. Are a logistical nightmare with problems ranging from floating fluids to shrinking manhoods. Apparently up there, you guys have shrinkage.
What?
Shrinkage everywhere.
The astronomer compared sex in space to having intercourse while skydiving, but added that it was not impossible, but that it's just very challenging up there. So anyway.
Because of the shrinkage?
I guess. Mm. And the floatage. And I don't know.
Floatage?
Floatage.
Floatage, shrinkage, all that stuff,
yes.
Huh?
Uh-huh.
The space station seems to recycle a lot of the fluids.
How do you mean?
That could, well, when you go to the bathroom, there's a machine that cleans it up and puts it right back in the tap.
Yep.
Is that why they named it Tang?
I don't know. I don't know. That could be. That would be a troublesome, eating Morty's essence.
Ew.
Mm-hmm.
Or drinking Morty's. It's mm-hmm. kind of a tricky thing.
It's difficult, isn't it?
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Mm-hmm. You want to hear more thoughts that women had on the mysteries of the ween?
Yeah, I remember being a teenager with my best friend, and we were trying to figure out how you guys
let your fluid go. Did you just look at it and go, ready, aim, fire?
You didn't know what made it go.
Right.
Mm-hmm.
We didn't understand.
Mm-hmm.
I still don't know that I understand, but I stopped wondering.
It has to be coaxed.
It just works.
Yeah. This one girl says, I thought your balls had their own individual sack so that there were two sacks on each guy.
Oh. Okay.
That each ball had its own bowling bag.
Uh-huh.
Bowling ball bag.
No, they share, right?
Huh?
They share, right?
One bag, two balls.
Okay.
Generally, that's the preferred method. Mm. Some people have different things. When he made it move all by itself, it blew my mind.
Okay.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, that's really weird, isn't it? Ball skin constantly moving. Surreal. It's like a moving magic eye painting. It's impressive to me, too.
Undulating?
That we have no control over, you know.
Really?
None. Oh. Uh-uh.
It's all temperature regulation.
I have more to say about that, but... here we go. You hear the pause, and then there's a little bit of grunting, and then he barfs up more words.
Uh-huh,
yeah, we have no control over that at all.
Huh.
Mind of its own.
Interesting.
It's a lava lamp down there. Have you ever stared?
No.
Oh, yeah.
They're not pretty to look at.
No. But there's a fascination. My wife has stared and clapped.
Like, look at it go. Mm-hmm, or...
mm-hmm. She's applauded the show.
Well, that has to feel good.
It is a lot like a lava lamp.
I'm never going to look at a lava lamp the same.
Mm-hmm. Derek, you're on the DSC. What's going on?
I have a comment about, sitting down to pee.
Mm.
Yeah, as you know, it's going to go everywhere.
Yeah.
So you spend a few years in prison, and then maybe something happens. The guy who his brother left a bag of meth in his pocket. You remember me.
Yep.
Yeah, well, I ended up getting in a little trouble with a guy in there and hurt him real bad, and they sent me to a place called The Shoe. You do not stand up to pee in The Shoe. Well, at least I didn't. Because your cellie's head is about 10 inches away from where you pee.
Gotcha.
And as we all know, that doesn't work.
No.
I learned to sit down to pee. I still sit down to pee unless I'm out in public. That's not happening. But at home and everywhere else, it's just a cleaner, healthier way to live.
All right. All right.
And I'll tell you what. If anyone has a problem with me sitting down to pee, I'm 6'3" and I weigh 240 pounds.
All right. Easy, easy. I don't need your threats. I don't need your threats here, Derek. We understand. We're all afraid of you. You've been to prison.
Mm-hmm.
That's why when you walk in and you see Derek sitting on a urinal, it's because he learned it in prison. And he doesn't want to hear any of your questions. Because otherwise he'll beat the crap out of you.
Mm-hmm.
All right? Mm-hmm. Good. Thank you, Derek. All right, what else?
Gabriela Cerruti, she's Argentina's presidential spokeswoman. She made headlines over the weekend after she was spotted on Instagram entering a contest to win a dildo. Promoted under the slogan, your best friend, give it a gift.
She is who?
She is the presidential spokeswoman. So press secretary kind of thing is the...
Who is Joe Biden's press secretary right now, Emily?
That chick.
That's right.
Uh-huh.
Mm-hmm. I can't name her.
She has an unusual name, and I did not commit it to memory.
Her name could be Jill, for all I know.
No, it's not that easy to remember. It's not simple.
Well, that puts neither of us any closer to knowing it. Mm-hmm. But that's who it is, the press secretary of Argentina. That's... She was trying to win a dildo.
Uh-huh. Mm. And social media users jumped on their... online to express their disappointment because they say she needs to be working 24 hours a day, 7 days a week to save the country.
Oh, people were critiquing?
Yes, and she should not be worried about...
We have Hunter Biden here to run all those contests for us.
One TV commentator saying half the country sunk in poverty, 4 million homeless, inflation close to 3 digits per year, the dollar totally out of control, the economy paralyzed. Meanwhile, she's in a contest to win a dildo.
I have nothing to add to that.
Then there's a shoemaker who has teamed up with a sex toy manufacturer to create a product that, you know, tells a story.
It's a shoemaker and a dildo at the same time? It's a shoe and a dildo? Is this like the knife that comes out of the front of James Bond's shoe?
No. Oh. It's no longer a dildo.
Oh.
It was a dildo in a past life.
Ah, repurposed.
Yes.
Hmm.
It's been upcycled.
Mm-hmm. Do you do that? Do you throw all your dildos out in the blue garbage can?
I don't have any toys.
Okay. All right. I didn't know they were getting recycled.
Apparently, if they've been deemed damaged or defective.
You get a mailer? Like, I get a mailer like twice a year saying, we're doing our computer scrap drive.
Oh.
Because they don't want computers to go to the landfills.
Right. Electronics recycling, right?
I don't recall seeing the flyer saying it's our twice annual dildo scrap drive. Do you guys do that? Do you recycle your dildos?
Well, it sounds like if it's...
Emily, said, I'm sorry, Chris. Yes. Tell me, Chris, do you recycle your dildos? You seemed anxious to be the first to answer.
Well, I think
do you recycle your dildos? It's yes or no.
Oh, my God.
It's yes or no.
Do you still beat your wife? No.
All right. What? So, Sarah, do you
How
get
is that
this?
Not an analogy? Wasn't it? I don't know. Dildos beat your wife? Nothing? Nothing?
Did you just do an analogy?
No, sir.
What did you do? You gave me a question that was similar to the question I asked? That's almost like an analogy.
It's
pop out that jar. Why not? Yes, indeed. Thank you, Sarah. It's a keen ear you've got over there. All right, Chris Boyer does not recycle his dildos. Therefore, he is not helping to make these shoes. Uh-huh. Go ahead.
Sarah, you don't recycle dildos.
Apparently you do.
No, you don't.
Well, you're not a friend of the earth, and you're not a good person doing good things to make the world gooder today. Mm-hmm. You have no place on this show today, ma'am. This is all about good people today. Well, what happened?
Apparently, these were never made it out of the plant. They were either damaged or defective.
They were bunk dildos.
Yes. So then they were given to this other company who turned them into chunky, wearable, stylish shoes. If you'd like to check them out, they're called Plastic Soul, S-O-U-L.
Mm-hmm. So that the plastic doesn't go to waste.
Yes.
How can that be a bad thing?
Oh.
Like my dildo shoes, Bob? Mm-hmm. Okay.
And then they have a
Is there a pair of shoes that you won't be caught dead in? It's like, there's just no way I'll wear that kind of shoe.
I used to say that about Crocs.
You should still say that about Crocs.
Mm-hmm. But if someone said, here's a pair, you got to wear it for a day, fine, or whatever. I don't know. I hear they're extremely comfortable.
Oh, no.
So I would be caught in them rather than be
dead.
We've lost her.
I'm not saying we're
She's open to Crocs.
Them.
She's gone.
It's an open mind.
Comfy.
Crocs, Birkenstocks.
I know. How dare you?
It's a dead heat. It's a photo finish.
Oh, you're full of it.
For hideousness?
You wish.
Do you wear socks with either one? There we go. Sweaty feet. Good. Let's add that into the mix.
Right. And then sweaty just taking them off at the theater.
White out. Ugh. I don't know. It's a dead heat. What do you think, Boyer?
Crocs are horrible. And she's...
And Birkenstocks?
Horrible.
Uh-huh. But it's a dead heat. Can you choose one or the other?
They're both.
That's right. What I'm saying.
They're both awful.
You are
I agree
all
with them.
So because wrong.
The Birkenstocks, even though they might be slightly more showick.
Showick?
Shoe-like.
Shoe-like. Is that a word? Showick?
Showick.
That's a word?
Showick.
It is now, if you can say it.
If you can say it, it's a word.
Uh-huh.
Yes, exactly.
They do denote patchouli oil, no bath for 3 days, and big bushy pits and other places.
You got big bushy pits in other places?
Still no.
To me, Crocs just look like those wooden shoes that the Dutch people wear, only they're made of rubber instead of wood. They the same shape.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Those have been around a long time.
Both of them
super duper fashionable.
Sarah, you know if Britney was wearing glitter Crocs, you would go out and get a pair.
Damn you, she wouldn't do that. She wouldn't do that.
But if she did, you would.
And that's the only reason I own white Birkenstocks is because Brittany wore them.
If she wore them as gloves, you'd come to work tomorrow with Crocs on your hand. And God, everyone's doing it.
We'll wait and see. There's no way.
They've already got holes in them for your fingers to get through. God. What a mess. All right. I don't know why we got onto that.
The sex toy shoes.
Oh, yeah.
Is
That's
there any
right.
shoe that you wouldn't be caught dead in?
Well, those are taken, yeah. I don't like the whole beige tennis shoe look, you know. I'd like to think I got two more years before I get into those. Haven't you given up by then?
I think so.
What is it about beige tennis shoes that are so appealing to old people? What is it? The white is too hard on my eyes. It's so bright. What is that?
Yeah, it's just very neutral. Doesn't show stains.
Stains. Everything with the stains. It's the last pair of shoes I'll ever have to buy. God.
Yeah.
The home of the DSC. 101.5.
KGB.
You want to hear what more women are saying that they didn't and maybe still don't understand about men and what's going on down there?
Yeah, I may learn something.
Because, you know, we don't understand a damn thing what you got going on.
Uh-huh.
No one does.
No, we barely do.
Yep. DJ says, I thought it would be slimy for some reason. I was so pleasantly surprised. I was very young.
Wait, then the whole thing would be slimy?
She thought his peen would be slimy. Yeah. I thought... How goofy it looks when flaccid. It's just this weird stretchy knob hanging out between your legs. I mean, how can that not feel weird when you walk? How do you walk? How doesn't everything squish between your thighs with every step? It still blows my mind a little bit when I stop to think about it. And then this girl says that it floated in a bath. I didn't expect that.
Oh, my God. Well, that's got to feel weird.
I get a little bit goofy when I'm nervous, so I did the up, down, left, right movement with it, which is kind of fun. My husband said, did you just use a cheat code with my wiener?
That's not a move. Don't you try that at home.
I will now. Power up. Let's go. All right. We got more crackpot news here.
Yes, sir.
Tell me what else is going on.
A Pennsylvania man is saved after a 15-foot snake wrapped around his throat. Number one.
God. That's not good.
No. Police arrived in the nick of time, fatally shooting the snake in the head and releasing its death grip. It happened last week in rural Fogelsville, where the 28-year-old man kept snakes as pets. A police spokesman said it was probably among the most horrific calls they've had to respond to. I'm Trey Thomas.
I don't know if this would be true, but Fogelsville just sounds like it should be like in Tennessee.
Yeah,
it does. Something like that. Anyone got it? Mm-mm. Fogelsville? Mm. Yeah. What kind of snake? A python?
It didn't say the kind of snake. Yeah. Just Fogelsville is in Pennsylvania.
Oh.
Wow.
Oh, surprised. All right. Glad he's okay. Too bad for the snake.
Yeah.
Snake just doing his thing.
Oof.
15-foot snake.
Uh-huh. Mm. His pet.
You don't date a guy with a snake.
No.
All right. What else do we have?
A 73-year-old woman was injured when a sailfish jumped out of the water and stabbed her with its bill. She was aboard a
fishing boat. From hell's heart, I stab at thee.
She was aboard a fishing boat off the coast of Florida when the 100-pound creature charged the boat after getting caught on a line. Catherine had no time to react and was impaled in the groin.
Oh. Wow.
Two men aboard the boat kept pressure on the wound until she could be flown to a hospital.
Sailfish. What a terrible task.
Sailfish can grow up to 10 feet long and are known for their sword-like bill and giant dorsal fins.
The saber.
Poor lady.
Pointy, big pointy needle on the end of those fish. I've seen that. Yeah. I've seen videos of those sailfish coming right into the boat.
Oh.
Going kamikaze on these guys.
Right.
Or defending themselves.
Uh-huh.
Yeah.
Yeah. This one went right in her.
Into the groan.
Number two.
And you don't believe in meant to be, but somehow you are meant for me, it's true.
Who's this, Chris Boya?
Rihanna.
No. Try again. Been in the news a lot lately.
J-Lo?
There you go.
Yeah. So Ben and Jen are honeymooning in Paris, and apparently when they were at dinner the other night, paparazzi caught Ben crying.
Jesus.
Did he realize what he'd done?
And J-Lo embraced him in a hug, and his head is on her shoulder. He was also caught snoozing, just mouth open at one point during the honeymoon. So it's been All the emotions for Ben on this honeymoon. The minister who married them is speaking out about their nuptials.
Yeah.
The Little White Wedding Chapel minister, Ryan Wolf, said it was an emotional moment they shared with one another. It was real and evident for sure. After seeing them and the love they have for each other, I 100% believe they will last. They will make it. I believe they found their soulmates. I really do believe they're meant for
this each other. This is a midget priest dressed up like Elvis saying all this stuff?
I think I am, possibly.
All right. Good. Thanks.
Mm-hmm. Kid Rock had to cancel his North Dakota show due to weather, and so naturally the fans trashed the place, which was lovely and delightful. And then things got crazy over to a Rage Against the Machine concert, number 3.
So this is Tom Morello?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
And this was their closer, Killing in the Name, and a fan jumped the barrier and ran on stage. So a security guard attempted to grab the fan with a flying tackle, but plowed into Tom Morello instead and knocked both of them off the stage and onto speakers below.
I saw this. It was wild. The crazy storming fan dodged the security guard, and the security guard flying tackle takes Tom Morello. What do you think that is? 6'8", 10 feet down?
Easily.
From the
They were unharmed. They finished the song and the show. But,
when I did that thing with Sammy Hagar and his band up in Burbank, the guitarist fell off the stage.
I remember you telling us
that. When they were walking out to perform at the iHeart Theater in Burbank, the guitarist fell off the stage because it was dark and they weren't used to the stage.
Yeah.
And he didn't see that there was no step there and broke his leg.
Oh, my gosh.
Yeah.
And that
it's a dangerous fall.
Yeah.
It's not just like 2 feet. It's down quite a ways.
And the frontman of Rage Against the Machine injured his leg during a show on this tour. They're not having the best luck.
Is Tom Morello okay?
Yeah, they say that
he got nailed like a football move.
Yeah. At the time, he was able to get back up and perform. I don't know if later, after the adrenaline wore off, if there was hurt.
This guy for Sammy Hagar played the entire set with a broken leg.
That's crazy.
Mm-hmm. Wow. Show must go on.
Mm-hmm.
All right, what else?
Ozzy Osbourne was here in town at Comic-Con on Friday, and he's been recovering from an operation that, as Sharon had said, would determine the rest of his life. That took place in mid-June. And so he was talking to ET and said it felt great to be making his debut appearance at Comic-Con. He said he missed seeing people. Number 4.
See people, you know. Yeah. That's been the hardest thing over the past 3 years because I've been trying to recover from my surgery. Yeah. I'm getting there, and
you say I'm gay now?
Said I'm getting there.
Are you sure he didn't say I'm gay now?
I'm not sure.
That could be the surgery he had.
Oh.
I've been trying to recover from my surgery. Yeah. I'm getting there.
He says I'm gay now.
Yeah, I think you're right.
Does Sharon know? That was the surgery he had.
I think she'll stay with him no matter what.
He said sexual reassignment surgery.
Oh. I've been trying to recover from my surgery. Yeah. I'm getting there. And it's a stroke. But I'm back, you know.
Okay. All right. Well, whatever. Uh-huh. We still love Ozzy. Doesn't matter to us. We aren't judgers. Mm-hmm. It's fine. It's cool. Mm-hmm. Good on you, Oz.
She did say it would determine the rest of their lives.
I'm gay now.
Oh.
All right. Anything else?
Yeah. Half of Americans now watch TV with closed captioning on because of muddled audio, hard to understand accents, or just because they enjoy the experience.
Yeah.
The use of subtitles is actually higher in younger demos. 72% of Gen Zers, which is more than Gen X or Boomers. And so they did a study to figure out who is the most mumbly mouthest of them all that people require closed captions for.
On TV and movies?
Yeah.
Hmm. Who is the... Okay, so are we supposed to guess this?
You can.
A present day performer?
Yes.
I see. Is it Ozzy?
I know.
Is it not Ozzy?
It's not Ozzy. No.
That would have been my guess.
Joe Biden.
Boy, is he ever.
Oh, man. I would guess Russell Brand.
I have been watching a Joe Biden news conference, and the closed caption says, "Your guess is as good as ours." Who did you say it was?
Russell Brand needs one.
Oh, he has that very thick, I guess, like Cockney accent kind of thing.
And he uses lots of big words. I love him, but it could help if I understood what he was saying. Follow along more.
His language is a real pleasure to listen to. Mm-hmm. He has quite the command of the king's English. Mm-hmm. I really enjoy listening to him. Mm-hmm.
It's not him.
It's flowery. Can we get a hint? Like something they've been in and we would know them
I think
that.
It would give it away. Oscar nominee. He has a recurring role on Peaky Blinders, which I don't think you watch.
Oh, no. It's so good. Who's on that? Oh, wait. No.
Recurring role. So not a main person, but.
Oh, yeah, I know. Tom Hardy?
Yes.
Tom Hardy.
Number
all right.
Four.
Let's listen to Tom Hardy.
Compilation of his mumbling.
Number four is Ozzy.
Oh, five, sorry.
Five, here we go.
Murders in his younger youth.
That's a lovely, lovely voice.
And Tony Brodsky.
And then I think maybe you know there's no devil.
Her ass would still be floating around in Surrey right now if it wasn't for me.
Ah, bollocks, mate. The pair of you, you two belong to each other.
And as Earth dies, remember, I will always, forever be Shinzon of Remus.
Hey, never mind, you put Nod, right?
1,300,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,
I remember when when he was in Batman.
Bane.
He was Bane in Batman, and no one could understand a damn word he said. Uh-uh. And I'm convinced that, because I've seen it so many times since then, I'm convinced that they went through and redubbed his lines.
Oh, to make it easier to understand him?
I'm convinced of it.
You can get it?
Hmm?
Now you get it?
I do.
But you didn't.
You can understand it before. Pass? Before, you couldn't understand a damn word he said. Mm-mm. Nothing. Because this guy, in case you haven't seen Batman, he wears like a, it's almost like the breathing device that scuba divers wear. Mm-hmm. He has like some sort of breathing device over his face. Mm-hmm. I don't mean a mask like a burglar wears a mask. He wears like a face mask. Like he's got
CPAP.
He's sleep apnea man. Yes. Exactly.
Yeah.
And you can't understand a damn word he says, but I think they fixed it.
Mm. Yeah. So other celebrities that made the list as people need captions to understand them. Sean Connery, Michael Caine, Benedict Cumberbatch, Idris Elba, James McAvoy, Sophia Viagra, Arnold Schwarzenegger, and Jackie Chan. There are only two U.S. actors mentioned on the list, Johnny Depp and Brad Pitt.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Yeah. Johnny Depp and Brad Pitt mumble. Mm-hmm. They do. Those other ones you talked about, I understand Sophia Vergara way better than Johnny Depp. Way better. And those first like five or six, those Englishmen, Sean Connery and
Michael Caine,
all those guys. Mm-hmm. I'm clear as a bell.
They say Scottish accents are the ones that Americans struggle with the most, followed by Irish and then British accents. Then there's a small percentage of viewers that like to use subtitles to learn a new language.
Oh, God. Look, we're watching the TV show, so we don't have to read the book.
Right. We don't want to learn. We're checking out, man.
Not about that.
That is how Eric said he learned how to speak a lot of English.
Is that right?
Yeah. Watching American TV. So. Yeah.
English is easy. Come on. I was born speaking it. Come on. All right, what else?
Netflix is in the news as they're trying to come up with a new way to stop you from sharing your password. They're testing a feature called Add a Home, where users will be asked to pay an additional fee if they see the account being used away from your home for 2 weeks. It would be an extra charge of $2.99. And they're also talking about adding a cheaper ad-supported option for subscribers, but that would not include their entire library of options.
I have an idea for Netflix to improve their viewership. Mm-hmm. Put on stuff we want to see, like you used to, before you got cruddy. Thank you.
Tomorrow they have a new documentary, Shania Twain, Not Just a Girl.
It's a what?
A Shania Twain documentary.
Documentary?
Uh-huh.
Where?
It follows the singer as she transcends genres across borders and amid triumphs and setbacks.
I can tell you all you need to know about Shania Twain. Hung out with her in Paris. She's tiny. She is as cute as she looks. And that's all you need to know.
Well, thank you. You just saved me however long the documentary is.
You're welcome.
And do you remember Manti Te'o?
Yeah, he was a charger, right?
Yeah.
Catfish?
Yeah, he was catfished. And so that's a documentary coming to Netflix, Untold, The Girlfriend Who Didn't Exist.
Mm. Poor guy. Felt bad for him.
I know, me too.
I mean, he hasn't gotten over that. That's what people think of when you say that about that guy.
Yeah.
Yeah, no one's like, oh my God, he's a fantastic whatever position he plays, because I can't tell you. Right. Is he running back?
I thought he was defensive.
Okay, there you go.
I don't know. I have no recollection.
No one knows. We just know
whatsoever.
That he fell in love with some girl who was actually a guy or something like that.
When he was at Notre Dame, he was a linebacker.
All right. There you go. No clue.
So that will be coming to Netflix.
Poor guy never came up with a career that overshadowed the catfishing incident.
No.
That's
poor
a bummer.
Yeah.
That is a bummer.
Uh-huh.
All right, anything else?
No, that's about it.
Dear Dave, I'm a good person. I like to leave shopping carts askew all over the parking lot to make sure someone has job security. No need to thank me. My satisfaction is served by the kind looks I'm getting for doing it. That's Rogan checking in. Thank you, Rogan. Thank you for being a good person, doing good things to make the world a gooder place. Nick says, Dear Dave, I used to scoop out all the chicken in the chicken soup at Soup Plantation when I was serving myself because I know that people who go there to eat who are watching their calories. Closing in on 10 o'clock here at the House of Rock, 1015 KGB San Diego. Allie's going to have a brand new word for you coming up in a minute here, and that's going to be your nationwide keyword that you need to win $1,000 in inflation compensation. She's doing it all day today. And then Clint August all afternoon. And we'll pick it up again tomorrow morning right here. All week long. All throughout the day. Just remember that word changes every hour. Mike writes to me, Dave, I'm a good person. I like to drive 5 miles per hour under the speed limit in the fast lane so that the drivers behind me don't get speeding tickets. That's good people. Dear Dave, to conserve water in these drought conditions, I poop in the bushes. It also acts as a nice treat for puppies like yours. Signed, Anna. Sure are a lot of good people out there.
Yeah.
It started out, the good people list, started out with a guy who said, you know, whenever I see anyone's got a ticket, a parking ticket on their windshield, I like to take it off their windshield and throw it in the garbage so they don't have to worry about paying. And, oh, well, they're going to have to pay. And so I got so upset about it. I don't like that.
He doesn't well, see then, the gooder in it.
Well, then wait till you hear the rest of the show today. You're right, Emily. He could not see the gooder.
Mm-mm.
It's hard sometimes.
Yeah.
But it was refreshing to hear how many people, good people, there are in this good world making the world gooder every day. Right, Sarah?
I loved it.
Mm-hmm.
Every single one of them.
What else did we do today?
Well, it was a rough day for the chainsaw because, Dave, you went to see the Crawdad movie over the weekend and Chainsaw was throwing a fit over the casting of the movie because it's not who he pictured in his head when he read the book.
I can't believe he read the book.
I know.
I mean, I'm at this movie and I'm like, all right, whatever. They're going to have ice cream at the end of this thing. I'm sitting in a chair and relaxing. He read, I mean, it's a chick movie. Uh-huh. So it's a total chick book. I may have been caught at a chick movie, but you'll never catch me dead reading a chick book. He read the whole, he loved it though.
He sure did.
He loved it.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So he's throwing a hissy fit and he will not see this movie yet. No. Yet.
Yeah. You guys have any intention on seeing this movie?
No, sir.
No.
That's a big fat no from everybody.
Maybe when it's on TV at home.
Yeah. Okay.
Not going to go to the theater.
Yeah. All right.
But
what
you
else?
You got Baked Bear after that. So there's your 10 for the weekend. Dave, you bought a new pair of sneakers made from water bottles. And guess what? They feel like they're made out of water bottles.
Sure do. I get why they say that.
They don't need to say that. You just know.
Mm.
Stranger Things is going too far with the whole closed captioning things with squelching music and some kind of music with moist tentacles.
Yeah. It was driving me crazy.
We did hear some good things that people were doing to make the world a gooder place.
Right.
So many good ones. Some included a guy who likes to leave the left blinker on while driving so people know which side of the road to drive on. One guy likes to stay seated when an old lady hops on the bus to help strengthen her leg muscles.
That's right.
One guy likes to make sure all the buttons on the elevator are working before getting off. One guy likes to bang on the stall to make sure the person on the pooper is okay in there.
Is everything okay in there?
And one 6'3", 300-pound man likes to sit next to the lonely woman on the train and follow her home to make sure she's safe.
Just looking out for her. These are all good people. Thank you, good people. Thank you.
Listener Kyle went to go see Top Gun over the weekend and was horrified to see people use blankets and put their bare feet on the seats. So we updated him. Bare feet on the seats, totally acceptable. Guys bringing blankets means they're whacking it under there. We had a rush threesome today for SeaWorld tickets, and it was a race to see who could get nobody first. And listener Joe did, so he wins.
It was a nice attempt by Emily to change her answer after she'd been buzzed out.
Hey, I got to try.
Absolutely. Normally that would work on me, but not today.
You're too crafty for me.
Dave, you recently learned that Austin Butler meshed his vocals with Elvis for the new movie. So then you went over a list of actors who sang in movies and we guessed whether they really sang or lip-synced. J-Lo didn't sing in Selena, which Boyer knew because he just didn't think J-Lo could pull off Selena.
Right. Mm-hmm. Too challenging.
George Clooney did not sing in Oh Brother, Where Art Thou. Zac Efron did not sing in High School Musical, which me and Emily still don't want to believe.
Mm-mm. Just the first one.
Mm-hmm. Tom Cruise sang all of his songs in Rocks of Ages. And yes, Britney Spears sang every damn word.
Damn right she did. Damn right she did.
Listener Erica found out that her boyfriend is sharing their intimate sex details with his mother. Boyer says the mother could be helpful since she's more experienced and she could coach the son on how to improve his moves. And this led to the Airtight Mommies as the name of Dave's new band. We learned that astronauts are not supposed to whack it in space. They can't have gobs of goo getting all over these space equipment up there. And apparently they think it's because women astronauts could end up pregnant. We learned that Birkenstocks are more shoeick than Crocs. Shoeick?
It's a word. Okay. You can say it. It's a word.
Ben Affleck is sleeping and crying during his honeymoon with J-Lo.
Sounds about right.
But finally, David, we learned that your junk is like a lava lamp and Nicola applauds it when it puts on a show.
She does. Get a little round of applause.
I love that.
All right, friends, let's do it again tomorrow here. Love your show.